Some NFL facts for you to chew on as we get set for the Jets and the Eagles. Jets have never beaten Philadelphia. 0-9 all-time. Only team they've never beaten in their history. 2-0, though, are those Jets. Last time they started 3-0, 2009. Rex Ryan and Mark Sanchez took them to the championship game. Eagles haven't been 0-3 since 1999. Why is that big? Because only five teams starting 0-3 ever have made the playoffs. So not very good odds, as you see. 2% of the time, if you're 0-3, you make the playoffs. That's why today, very big for Philadelphia. Down to the sidelines we go. The third member of our broadcast team is Pam Oliver.
Well, Kevin, after a brief workout, it was determined that running back DeMarco Murray should sit this one out. He told me before the game that he wasn't able to get that hamstring loose. He tweaked it this week in practice. He said, I'll be fine, though, and should be ready to go next week against Washington. Chip Kelly told me that it's ultimately up to the player. Back to you.
All right, Pam, so it's big news to DeMarco Murray, who hasn't gotten going yet at all for Philadelphia. Not playing, it'll be Ryan Matthews as the lead back. Jets took the toss. They elect to receive. Here is Zach Stacy, and here we go. As Stacy tiptoes his way across the 15, almost up to the 18-yard line. And we will see Ryan Fitzpatrick in his 11th season out of Harvard. Third different team he's led to a 2-0 start, and he's had a real good start, John.
He really has. He's protecting the ball well. They're running it very well, which is his best friend. And then they got Brandon Marshall outside, and when he's one-on-one, they're going to him. Fitzpatrick said, look for that early. Whenever he is one-on-one, we're going to give them a chance to cover.
Well, the Jets with their injuries, too. Eric Decker, their number two wideout, is not playing today with a sprained knee suffered at the end of the Indianapolis game. Bilal Powell starts out at tailback. Devin Smith, the rookie wide receiver, gets a start today. Here is Powell. And on the first carry, Powell's going to pick up about four. So who are these New York Jets that are undefeated on the early season? Well, it's been a great start for their new head coach, Todd Bowles. +8 equals 2-0. They're unbeaten because they're a +8 in turnover differential. The dominant defense, they've been great. John said he thinks they could be the best in the league. And can Fitzpatrick pilot this offense, especially today, without Eric Decker, who had a big game Monday night against Indianapolis? We shall see. And we get a whistle. Gene Steratore is our referee today.
False start. Offense number 81. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
Interesting in that we talked to Ryan Fitzpatrick Friday, John, and we talked actually a lot about his cadence. Might have worked against his own team.
Yeah, worked against him there, but it has been a real weapon for Ryan Fitzpatrick and the Jets this year. From the gun, he gets a lot of teams to jump off sides in the first couple of weeks of the season.
The Jets do this a lot. They run an empty set as they go five wide. On second and 12, three-man rush, gets rid of it quickly. Here's Jeremy Curley. He's been a forgotten man for this Jets offense. He's been a good player the last few years, but with the injuries, Curley will get more time today.
And Kevin, in talking to Ryan Fitzpatrick with the injury to Eric Decker, we asked him point blank who steps up, and he said Jeremy Curley is the guy that's going to have to. He had a great week of practice, and he said look for him to have a big week. He catches one early.
So a third down and five. Four-man rush. Fitzpatrick gets rid of it and caught and then dropped. They're going to say that Curley was down. Now the mark. And we'll see where the spot is. It looks from our angle might be a bit short. Let's see.
See Curley bring the ball in. Short. I'm not so sure that would have been a catch had been challenged, because going to the ground, he did not secure the football, but short nonetheless.
Yeah, I think you're right. I think if that's a play that he got a first down, Chip would have challenged that, but instead it's a three and out for the Jets offense, and now the very dangerous Darren Sproles to return it. Two punt return touchdowns last year. High and short from Quigley, and a good Jet bounce will take it right around the 30-yard line. For the Eagles this year, it's been a rough start, that's for sure. The run game, which the last 2 years has been second best only to Seattle, has been Not so good this year, 70 total yards. So what's going on? DeMarco Murray, a big sign in the offseason, led the league after 2 weeks last year. This year, 11 total yards. Today, not playing. I mean, give you an idea. Look where Murray is on this list. 96th. You got Nick Foles and Carson Palmer and Ryan Mallett, quarterbacks ahead of him. How in the world can that happen? You ask yourself. It's got to change.
Well, it does. And, you know, it's not just on DeMarco Murray. First of all, they need to get running downhill. They've been running sideline to sideline. That offensive line needs to play better. But they get the run game going, it will help everyone.
One thing you may see today is a lot more of Darren Sproles everywhere. Sproles, the running back, is going to line up as a wide receiver at the top of your screen. And so here's Sam Bradford, week three as a Philadelphia Eagle. First and 10. Here's Sproles. He gets it up the middle, breaks a couple tackles, and then brought down to the ground at about the 34-yard line. So he's going to pick up about five. David Harris on the tackle. And, yeah, the Eagles and Chip Kelly, they will hurry it up. They will get to the line right away and try and get those first downs and get that pace going. Second and 5. Four-man rush. Bradford nearly intercepted. David Harris could have had that. Now a very late flag from the far side of the field. And this looks to be in the secondary of the Jets.
Looks like it's going to be holding on the defense. But David Harris dropped an interception. Would have been all for naught.
Prior to the pass, holding defense, number 31. 5-yard penalty, automatic. First down.
It's on Antonio Cromartie. And so the Eagles' first downs have been in a premium. They'll take it.
Well, there's Cromartie working in the slot against Riley Cooper. And as Cooper goes inside, he gets a handful of jersey and the back judge all over.
So a first down. Why is that big? Look at the Eagles. They've got 7 first downs and 2 first halves of football. They're going to give this time to Ryan Matthews, who breaks through. And Matthews still going, puts the head down, and he's down inside the 35. It's a gain of 27 for the guy getting the reps with Murray hurt today.
Well, this is the type of running they needed. Whoever was playing running back was downhill, tackle-breaking running. Prior to that this season, it's been sideline to sideline. We're seeing back to the basics, and it's paying dividends for the Eagles early.
The Eagles already 2 first downs. That's big for them. They throw it out of the backfield, and Matthews couldn't make the catch. Throw was a little high.
Kevin, interesting, you know, in talking to Todd Bowles, he knew that the Eagles were a team that had a lot going on, not a lot of good things. And so he knew that they were going to have to match the intensity of the Philadelphia Eagles. When you got a wounded dog, they're going to come out fighting, and the Eagles are.
Eagles had 70 total rushing yards coming into today. They've got 32 in the first couple of minutes here. Second and 10. Quick hitter Matthews makes a good catch, and he is absolutely buried. Calvin Cryer was there first.
Talk about this Jets defense being strong at all levels. Guys like Wilkerson up front, David Harris in the back end, and Calvin Cryer is a guy who's played outstanding football at the safety position. A tough player, great tackler for this defense.
Play clock at 2. They get it off. They need to get to the 26. Bradford throwing that way. He's got it to Matthews. It's a first down inside the 20 to Jordan Matthews. A pickup of 17.
Well, and they get first downs. That's when the tempo starts to take effect. Watch Jordan Matthews in the slot working on screen. Great throw by Sam Bradford. This Eagles team looking much more efficient, much sharper than they've been in the first 2 games.
This is not even an exaggeration. In this one drive, they've looked better than they did the entire Cowboys game last week. And they've got a first and 10 at the Jet 20, their opening drive of the game. Sproles in the backfield with Bradford. Going to give it to Sproles. Sweep left. Sproles has room inside the 15. Getting some good blocking there for Wilkerson. Brought him down. I mean, here's the idea of what they've done in the first half, John. I mean, today, 3 first downs on the opening drive.
And you know what it is, Kevin. They're coming out ready. They aren't thinking. They're hitting people in the mouth. And when you don't do that, you have people in your backfield. Today, they're controlling the line of scrimmage. And we're seeing that with the positive yardage.
Matthews from the 15 sneaks his way up the middle, and he's down inside the 10 for a first down. And this drive, the Eagles are flying. And they're going to have a first down and goal.
And when you talk about downhill running, what do I mean? This is exactly what downhill running is. Get the ball, get under the center, and go straight ahead and said, Ryan Matthews, we're going to control the line of scrimmage. You go get us a couple more. That's exactly what Matthews does. And this is the back to the basics that the Eagles have been talking about.
On first and goal, three-man rush. They're going to set up a middle screen, and Sproles amazingly caught that for David Harris, belted him, and now they say incomplete.
Watch David Harris right here in the screen game. He's playing a zone coverage, but he sees it and he goes and gets it, and that's what you have to do in the screen game. These linebackers for the New York Jets often overlooked because they're so good up front and they're so good in the back end, but David Harris and DeMario Davis can play some big-time football.
Ninth play of the drive. Eagles rushing yards a game. They've already surpassed their average. Almost dropped the handoff, and the Jets are there to get Sproles.
And this is where this front, you got big boys like Leonard Williams, the first round draft pick. That's penetration. Calvin Pace coming off the edge. That's an attacking style defense that the Jets bring.
For Philadelphia. Bradford throwing, end zone, Miles Austin incomplete, overthrew him, and the Eagles will settle for a field goal try.
Miles Austin had separation on Cromartie. You see the little fade route. Austin starts to separate right there, but an overthrow by Sam Bradford.
So the Eagles with a good looking drive, and now they'll have to settle for three, as Cody Parkey will attempt a 30-yard field goal. The Pro Bowler last year. And that's up and right through. So the Eagles strike first. Long drive results in a field goal. 3-0. They're on top of the Jets in the first. Eagles have their best drive of the first half so far this season. Not even close, but they couldn't punch it in. Jets very good in the red zone. And they settle for a 30-yard field goal to take a 3-0 lead.
I like what they did, Kevin, though. They got up to the ball, they stopped thinking so much, and they played football, old school football.
Parkey's kick is rolls out of bounds. Boy, just when you're giving them some accolades, you kick the ball out of bounds and you give the Jets the ball on the 40. That's no way to go.
Zach Stacy looked like a third baseman waiting for the bunt to go foul. Was just playing the waiting game. Eventually it did, but not what the Eagles want with such a great start.
Free kick out of bounds on the kicking team. The ball will be placed at the 40-yard line. First and 10, New York Jets.
So the Jets have good field position. Eagles running game is off and running so far. They've got the early lead. Eagles have some issues defensively. They've got three starters out today. Then Taylor Hart is one of their backups on the line. The two middle linebackers, Alonzo Kendricks, out. And we'll see how that affects them today. It's a Jets first and 10 from their own 40. And they're going to give to Powell. And Powell gets stuffed at the line. So one of those guys filling in is Jordan Hicks. He's the rookie. But you got Hicks and D'Amico Ryan's a veteran filling in for the two guys. But John, lose a lot of speed there, right?
Oh, you do. You really do with Kiko Alonso. Remember, that's the guy they traded LeSean McCoy for. And Michael Kendrick's probably the most dynamic player on this defense. And so what you have, though, is a luxury. A guy like D'Amico Ryans, who's been a Pro Bowl player in year 10, has slowed down a little bit. And Jordan Hicks, a rookie that they say is unfazed by the pressure and very much knows what he's doing out there.
Eagles defense has been on the field a lot, but the D overall has played pretty well. Fitzpatrick, far side, and he's got a completion out there. So Quincy Enunwa makes his second NFL reception. It'll be a third down and short.
This is what you've seen a lot from this Jets offense. Efficient play. Fitzpatrick with the short pass. Now all of a sudden they're in a third and four, very manageable, and that's what they've done a nice job this year, staying in these type of situations.
Take a look at the rookie Devin Smith. He's at the bottom of your screen. He's active for the first time, second round draft pick, and he can fly. Great speed starting today because of the injury to Eric Decker. Fitzpatrick, pressure up the middle, throws, tipped, caught, but an immediate tackle by Byron Maxwell as Marshall made the catch, but the Jets will have to punt.
Well, you like a couple things if you're an Eagles fan. First of all, Maxwell with tight coverage. But what I like is they've got him up doing what he does. He's a press corner. This year we've seen him off a lot. They've got him up in press against Brandon Marshall, and he covers him tightly, and they get off the field with the punt.
That's Darren Sproles back to receive. So good on the punt returns, two for touchdowns last year, led the NFL, averaging 13 yards a punt return last season. High kick. Sproles going to let it go. Good jet bounce, and they got it around the one. Well done by everybody. Marcus Williams got down there. Hang time of 4.6. And the Eagles have a long way to go, but they've got the lead, 3-0 over the Jets here at MetLife Stadium. So the Eagles' first half had been dreadful coming into today, and this is amazing, John. You see all those numbers. They had 70 total yards rushing their first two games. One drive, they've got 40. So a good start and a 3-0 lead, but here, backed up on their own two to start their second drive. Jets showing blitz. Here they come. Bradford gets rid of it. Incomplete. Had to hurry. And it'll be second down. David Harris, by the way, injured his finger, went back to the locker room. Say his return is probable after a good first drive for him. So Aaron Henderson, the former Viking, subbing in for him on the defense for the Jets.
Well, right away, Sam Bradford looking at the rookie, Nelson Aguilar, who they're very high on, but miscommunication between Bradford and Aguilar, and Sam Bradford has to throw it away.
There is Aguilar in motion. Ryan Matthews, the running back. Bradford going to hand to Matthews, trying to find the seam, and he's going to have a short game. Give him about two and a third and long. And John, this is where the Eagles have really had their issues too, because they've been in a lot of third and longs. Their third down percentage has been atrocious at 21%, but in third downs of 6 yards and over, they're 1 of 14 on the year.
Yeah, and that's not too far off the NFL average. And when you're in third and longs, it's hard to convert in this league. The guys up front are too good, the cover guys are too good.
Darren Sproles in the game on a 3rd and 7. Play clock at 1. And they don't get it off.
Well, Sam Bradford frustrated, but credit to these Jets fans, Kevin. They came out ready today.
Half the distance to the goal. Third down.
See Sam Bradford saying, let's go. He wants the ball, but communication, a lot of movement. Todd Bowles, a pressure defensive coach, showing pressure. Sam Bradford trying to get the protection right. And now an even tougher third down situation.
It's loud in here, John. 3rd down and 9. I think you're right on that communication. Four-man rush. Bradford gets it away. Sproles trying to get to the edge. Does. Across the marker. Oh, the speed of Darren Sproles. And I believe he's going to have enough for a first down.
And Darren Sproles in his 11th year. He's a guy they need the ball in his hands more. You lost a lot of explosion on this offense, and I think it's been showing with LeSean McCoy no longer here, Jeremy Maclin no longer here. So how do you get that? I think Darren Sproles, albeit in year 11, one of the most explosive players they have.
And he does pick up a first down, give him a little breathing room. Here's Sproles, one on near side, and he has nowhere to go. A big loss. Big loss. Quinton Coples is a guy that really destroyed that play.
And that looks more like what we've seen. You see Coples penetration in the backfield, running backs going sideways and getting whooped up front. But that's what this Jets defense can do as well. Very imposing front, Quinton Coples goes about 290, and he plays linebacker.
It's a loss of four. They'll try it again, this time straight up the middle. And that's going to get you a yard. And a third and long is coming your way for Philadelphia.
You know, in Philly's offense, it's all predicated on this, the pace. They want to get people going. They start to play faster when they get first downs. We saw it on the first drive. Now all of a sudden they're slowed, and you see the pace starting to slow down and the Jets starting to dictate.
And they told us, hey, first and second down, we've got to do better to avoid this. A third and 13. Bradford. Late blitz coming. Bradford unloads. Incomplete. He was looking for the rookie Aguilar. In and out of the hands. And hang on, there's a penalty back behind the line of scrimmage.
Looks like it's going to be a hold on the offense. And
holding. Offense number 76. Penalty is declined. Fourth down.
See in the middle of your screen. Barber with a fistful of jersey on Muhammad Wilkerson. But this Jets defensive front, very imposing, and Todd Bowles will keep you off balance with blitzes. He'll rush three, four, five.
Donnie Jones had one blocked last week, gets this off. Here's Curley, and he calls a fair catch. But again, the Jets will start with good field position here. Crowd into it, they wanted a flag, not there. Bradford unhappy, communication issues. His Eagles still up, three zip. Chris Ivory, the Jets' leading rusher, is active today despite groin and a quad injury. Haven't seen him yet. It's only the seventh offensive play. He'll rotate with Bilal Powell, but so far not on the field. First down. Fitzpatrick comes near side, and Enuma just dropped it. Quincy Enuma, first-year man from Nebraska, couldn't hold on.
Enuma and Curley, these guys are going to be called upon a little bit more because Eric Decker not in.
Earlier, the rookie who making his first NFL start today, first action period. Second rounder out of Ohio State, had a fractured ribs and a punctured long haul camp, so he was a little bit behind, but he's been healthy for a few weeks. Here, Fitzpatrick on the fake Curley. Good catch in traffic. Jeremy Curley, close, but I think a little short of the first down.
One of the reasons Ryan Fitzpatrick likes Curley so much is he can beat man-to-man coverage, and that's exactly what you have on the inside. Malcolm Jenkins, the safety, he moves up to the nickel, covering man-to-man, tight window, and Curley comes up with the big catch.
And so now a third down and one, and Zach Stacy in the game at running back. That's Brandon Marshall in motion. Fake to Stacy. Fitzpatrick near side. A tight end reception for the Jets to Cumberland. And a first down. John, it's like a unicorn. It's a second target all year to a tight end.
You seem so surprised. But the numbers dictate why you're so surprised. But you're going to see the boot action. And Cumberland going to slip out late. Really nice execution by Chan Gailey. That's what he does, the offensive coordinator. Downhill run game, the boot game off it, screen game, and then, oh yeah, you got Brandon Marshall outside. Whenever you leave him single covered, they're coming after you.
The Jets pick up their first down on the 49. Here's Powell. And Powell for a short game. First game break of the day. Let's check in with Kurt Menefee.
Well, after Joseph Randle ran in two touchdowns in Dallas's first two possessions, Atlanta answered with Devontae Freeman. A three-yard score. It's 14-7 still in the first quarter. Kevin, John, and Pam.
All right, Kurt, thanks. Cowboys without Tony Romo. Falcons trying to go 3-0. There's Chan Gailey, the new offensive coordinator for the Jets, in the middle with the Jets hat on. He's maybe new to the Jets, but he's been around this game for a long, long time. And he and Ryan Fitzpatrick have a great relationship. He was the head coach in Buffalo when Fitzpatrick was there on second down. Here's Brandon Marshall's first catch. And what a tackle. Marshall slung backwards by Malcolm Jenkins.
Well, this Eagles defense has been good, and Malcolm Jenkins has been phenomenal this season in that slot position. Malcolm Jenkins, you see him in the slot. He's going to come up, get Brandon Marshall, a big guy, tough guy to tackle in space, but Malcolm Jenkins, phenomenal this season.
That's a heck of a play. I mean, Marshall's such a physical guy. You don't see him get thrown around like that. And now a third and 17 for this Jets offense, and they'll go empty one more time with five wide. Four-man rush. They get it to Curley, and well played by the Eagles. Gets back to midfield, but nowhere near a first down. Jordan Hicks was there first.
Jordan Hicks, the rookie, makes a fantastic play in place of Michael Kendricks. He's in there as a rookie. A lot being called upon on Jordan Hicks, and Jordan Hicks does a tremendous job of coming up. Looked like there was space. Hicks comes up, makes a great tackle in space.
So Quigley will punt again. He dropped one inside the 20 last time. He had three punts inside the 20 against the Colts. He's done a nice job there. This one a little shorter and lower than the last kick. It bounces at the 10, and you know what? He does the job again. Inside the 10, well done by the Jets punter. And they will mark it at the 9-yard line. Now we get to see this Jets defense on the field one more time. It's the Eagles 3, Jets nothing, late first quarter. Good news for the Jets. One of their defensive leaders, David Harris, back in. He only missed a series with a finger injury. So he's back in the middle of that defense. 3-0 Eagles, 34 seconds to go in the first quarter. Philly, for the second drive in a row, really backed up after a good punt by the Jets. And they're at their own 9 to start this drive. Going to give to Matthews. Breaks through the original line of scrimmage. Good tough running from the former San Diego Charger. He's out to the 14 and a gain of 5.
Sometimes that's what you got to have. The Eagles line actually gets blown back on that, but Matthews, just with tough running, runs through tackles and gains positive yards.
Second and 5. Bradford has it blocked and comes near side for a completion. Jordan Matthews has it, and he's out around the 22-yard line. That's a first down for Philadelphia, and that should be the end of the first quarter. So, we saw one drive and a field goal, and then we saw some defense. But after one, it's the Eagles 3. Jets nothing from MetLife Stadium. 3-0 Philadelphia as we start the second quarter from MetLife Stadium. Along with John Lynch and Pam Oliver, I'm Kevin Burkhardt. As DeMarco Murray, if you just tuned in, inactive today. Suffered a hamstring injury during the week. Tried to go, not happening. So he's out. Ryan Matthews and Darren Sproles, the running backs. But here they go, empty backfield on a first and 10. Four-man rush and a good catch. And somehow Zach Ertz held on despite absorbing quite the hit.
Kevin, we talked about the explosion that left Philly when Macklin and LeSean McCoy leave. So it calls upon other people. I think Zach Ertz is one of those guys. He had sports hernia surgery in the preseason, starting to come back, get his feet underneath him.
Sproles tackled immediately. And so after the opening drive where the Eagles ran the ball pretty well, the Jets collapsing the interior pretty well on D.
Because of the success on first down, this is a third down situation you can deal with if you're the Philadelphia Eagles. Interesting to see the whole dynamic. Sam Bradford said he would not shy away from going at Darrell Revis. See Aguilar, the rookie, down working.
Yeah, Revis was questionable to play today with a groin injury, but he's played and just fine so far. 3rd and 3 for Philadelphia. Blitz coming. Picked up over the middle. Knocked away. Antonio Cromartie with those long arms knocked it down, and the Eagles will have to punt.
And you start to see why you think so highly of this defense. They've got guys up front they can bring in at the linebacker position. Then they've got multiple guys that can flat out cover man-to-man. When you have all that going for you, you can be a dominant defense, and that's what these Jets, I believe, will be.
Here's the punt. It's Curley looking for a chance. Back pedals. Breaks through, still going. Curley, good effort. Fans love it. As Jeremy Curley with a nice effort after a 53-yard punt, a 13-yard return. October means baseball, and FS1 continues to be your home for postseason action with the American League Division and Championship Series. Don't miss a moment of the drama and history. It begins October 8th on FS1 and streaming live on Fox Sports Go. So now the Jets get back on offense, and Riley Cooper limping off after that last series. We'll see Ryan Fitzpatrick if he can get something going. Just one first down so far for the Jets. This is Zach Stacy. And Stacy up to the 35 is going to gain two. Stacy came over in the trade from the Rams for a seventh round pick. Guy, a great rookie year. And then last year off to an okay start, and then he lost his job to Trey Mason.
All of a sudden, then they draft Todd Gurley down there, and he really wanted out. The St. Louis Rams made it possible. And what it's done for the New York Jets is you've got depth now. Mm-hmm. You've got Chris Ivory, Bilal Powell, and if in a jam, you can go to a guy like Zach Stacy, who's been productive in this league.
On Ivory, again, he was active today despite the quad injury. Also played through a groin injury last week. He hasn't been in yet, especially on that short yardage. I'd have to think he's hurting more now that we get closer to game time. On second down, plenty of time. Fitzpatrick airing it out, going deep for the rookie. Smith almost made a nice adjustment, but Nolan Carroll had good coverage the whole way down the field.
If you watched any Ohio State film the last couple of years, this is what Devin Smith does. He's a speed burner. Nolan Carroll does a nice job not going for the stutter. Gets his body in front of Devin Smith while looking for the ball. That's good cornerback play by Nolan Carroll.
Powell back in there for the Jets. Been a pretty good team on third down this year. 44% coming into today. This is a third and eight. Delayed blitz. Fitzpatrick hit as he throws, and it's incomplete. He got drilled. He was looking for Quincy Enunwa, and I'm not sure if the hit affected his throw.
Now watch Connor Barwin. This is a slick move. Watch him. He's going to fake like he's dropping. He comes, fakes like he's dropping, then says, no, I'm coming after you, Ryan Fitzpatrick. And he's the guy who puts the heat on Fitzpatrick. And then you've got tight coverage down the field by Byron Maxwell.
It's a good hold down the field, John. Whatever you got to do. Here's another punt. Great kick. Sproles all the way back to the 10. Going forward. Sproles making people miss. Still going. Darren Sproles. Look at him go. One man to beat. 89 yards. Touchdown. The sixth time in his career, he's done just that.
The little engine that could, Darren Sproles. He's done it throughout his career in his 11th year. And these don't look like 11-year-old legs. He's flying through those holes, breaking tackles. And when you get him in space, good night. They needed explosion, and Darren Sproles said, here you go.
Boy, that was a tremendous run. Patience at the beginning. I mean, that, John, that was an excellent punt to the corner. Directional kick. He couldn't do it better. But Sproles is as good as they come. And for an Eagles team that had seven special teams touchdowns last year, you know what? The offense is struggling. Get it from there. Extra point is up and good. And just like that, Philadelphia gets the spring in their step from the little guy, Sproles. And they've got a 10-0 lead over the Jets.
Yes, I do.
That was one heck of an effort by Darren Sproles. This is a great punt by Quigley. And he made, oh, we looked at the replay. It looked like he made about five guys miss.
Incredible. And that, you know, this is a team that needs players to step up. And Darren Sproles been a guy throughout his career. When his team needs big plays, he gives them. And Philly in dire need of something good to happen. Darren Sproles delivers.
They've been desperate. It's the first touchdown they've scored in a first half all year. Now they'll go the other way. There's Stacy on the kick return. And he's tackled at about the 22. Listen to this on the kick and the return.
You hear someone say, great punt, Quigley. And Darren Sproles says, not so fast. You say, missing tackles, sloppy tackling. But that's Darren Sproles. Five missed tackles on that punt return. And just tremendous, tremendous play from Sproles.
Keith DeSantis with the great shot on our cameras. But sometimes you just got to tip your hat. Jets did everything right but tackle Sproles.
Easy to say, tough to do. Up in there. That guy is low to the ground.
It's the 89 yards it goes for Sproles. So now the Jets, can they answer on offense? They've been quiet there. Just 37 total yards so far. From the 22, this is Powell. Good hole, left side, Bilal Powell. With a good gain on first down, he's out near the 30. Well, the Eagles were desperate for something. But, you know, how about the Jets? You know, they've played so well, everything going their way. Now they face adversity for the first time.
Adversity for the first time under Todd Bowles and Ryan Fitzpatrick. We talked in the open. The question is this offense. They've been playing with leads. Now all of a sudden you don't have a lead. How's Ryan Fitzpatrick in this offense going to respond? In his history, his Achilles heel has been the turnover when he gets in situations like this. We'll see if he can protect it and keep running efficiently.
Stacy with the run. Not much there. As he ran into a wall, Brandon Bear getting the start for the injured Cedric Thornton today. He makes the tackle on a third down and short is coming up. You know, it should point out, John, you know, as ugly as the Eagles start has been, you know, a couple breakdowns, their defense hasn't been the issue.
No, their defense certainly has, particularly when you take into account how many snaps they've played. Because of the ineptitude on offense, they've been on the field a lot, and they've actually done a very nice job.
Jets go empty on a third and two. Three-man rush. Coming near side. Incomplete. Jeremy Curley, the intended receiver, he was nowhere near. We've got a game break. Let's check back in with Kurt. That's a cheapie, John.
It just goes down in the books as an interception, but not that one, not on Mariota.
Here's Sproles back to receive. Just barely got his wind beneath him. And Quigley this time, another high kick, shorter. And he calls a fair catch. Nice job by Quigley on that punch. And Sproles with a fair catch. He's been the spark for the Eagles so far. They've got a 10-0 lead on the Jets. They're football here in the second. Chip Kelly told us yesterday, for the Eagles to be better, they've got to be better on first and second down, and they've got to sustain their running game. They've been so-so on both. They had a good first drive where they did that, but since, nothing much. The special teams touchdown from Darren Sproles, and it's 10-0 their lead. 10:46 to go in the half. Here's Matthews, gets the carry, and still on his feet. Good effort. It's a lot of work for a half a yard.
Well, you're seeing Ryan Matthews run tough, but I think from that first drive, now you're seeing this Jets front. You see controlling the line of scrimmage. You're seeing them start to assert themselves. So Chip Kelly's talking about that first and second down production. It starts up front and starts with controlling that line of scrimmage. Tough to do against this Jets defensive line.
Bradford coming near side. Matthews wide open, and he drops it. He could have scored on that and just couldn't make the play.
Well, Matthews going to come out of the backfield on a wheel route. Miscommunication between DeMario Davis and Calvin Pryor. Wide open, just takes his eye off the ball. And Kevin, you're exactly right. He may have gone untouched had he caught that ball.
Revis was the only guy even close. And so now a third down and 9. Play clock at 1. Get it off. Blitz picked up. Coming near side. Incomplete.
You go back to that drop by Matthews. You're going to see him come out of the backfield and just dropped in coverage. Look at the green grass down here. No one down here. If Ryan Matthews catches that ball, he may well go. Those opportunities you can't let go.
Here's an opportunity for Curley. From the 17, Jeremy Curley, 13-yard return before, gets out to to about the 27, loses his helmet. Jets football. They trail at 10-0. Jets trying to get something going on offense. They haven't done much, that's for sure. 45 total yards. And they trail 10-0 thanks to Darren Sproles, who returned a punt 89 yards for a touchdown. Start this drive on their own 27. Here's Fitzpatrick. Blitz coming. Dumps it off to Powell. Gets one block, but the Eagles played it well. They were all over. Benny Logan made the stop.
Logan makes that stop, but it's D'Amico Ryans flying up on his coverage to the outside that forces Bilal Powell to go back inside. Watch D'Amico Ryans come into the screen. Excuse me, it's Brandon Graham, 55, who flies up there. He misses the tackle, but that forces the ball back in to the Eagles defense.
And remember, the Eagles playing without three defensive starters today. Kendricks and Alonzo, their two middle linebackers, and Thornton, an excellent defensive end. Second down. Fitzpatrick near side. That's Stacy makes the catch. Turns upfield, gets to near the 30, but that's not going to be much. 2.5, and now a third down and long coming up.
Kevin, what you need to do, you need to get Brandon Marshall in. But, you know, I think what's really affecting that, no Eric Decker, no Chris Owusu, your second and third wide receivers. So now all of a sudden you can double Brandon Marshall. Marshall on the other side of the field had corner underneath, safety on top. And that's tough to get Brandon Marshall going when he's doubled constantly.
That's Powell in motion. Now Marshall on the bottom of the screen. See if Fitzpatrick looks his way. Third and seven. Three-man rush. Fitzpatrick curly. One-hander. Is he in? They say no. He's out.
What concentration by Jeremy Curley. You see right foot down, right elbow out. Good call by the officials.
Yeah, he's out. That's a good call.
The Jet fans are making their noise heard with their hearts rather than their minds, because clearly out of bounds was Jeremy Curley.
And the challenge flag has been thrown. Well, we got, I guess, look at another replay, but I didn't see it, John.
Right foot down. Now watch the right elbow.
You got.
As soon as that's out, he's out of bounds. It's out before that left foot.
Go ahead, John. Sorry.
No, Kev. I mean, it's just. I think this one's pretty simple.
After
right
review,
foot down.
The ruling on the film is confirmed. It was an incomplete pass. The receiver's elbow hits out of bounds first with possession. It's incomplete. The New York Jets are charged with their first time out of the half.
Todd Bowles got bamboozled by his crowd. You know, they were calling like it was like there he had a case, and there was no case to be made.
I wasn't even close, and they lose the challenge now. So regardless, they have one challenge left for the game. They won't be able to get another one. This is the sixth punt of the day already for Quigley. Jets offense has been completely quiet. Another good kick. Sproles, fair catch. Another ball, fair catch, actually. Good tackle. Jets are on it. Well, this Jets defense has been no joke this year. We know that. And their blueprint has been one that is really built with a secondary. Todd Bowles, a defensive coach. He ran those defenses in Arizona the last few years. And they went out and spent $150 million on a brand new secondary. Then, a defensive line that's great. They add Leonard Williams in the first round from USC, and he's starting now. 10 takeaways the first two games last year. They had 13 total. Add that together, and you got a defense that came into today number one in the league, allowing 8.5 points a game.
It's an impressive group. It really, the more film you watch, the more impressed you are with the Jets defense.
Here's Matthews. Matthews breaks through before Harris corrals him from behind, but he's got enough for a first down and a gain of 10.
You know, and I say that I think their best football's ahead of them for reasons like this. Their run fits aren't all the way there. Remember, new head coach, new defensive coordinator, learning a new system, and it's contrary to the type of system the front guys, they want blowing up field fast. They've been two gappers. It will take some time, but they'll get it right.
Matthews again, not much. And think about this Jets defense, too. You know, they're playing without last year's defensive rookie of the year, Sheldon Richardson. He was suspended for the first four games. That's for violating substance abuse policy. Then he had an incident, a speeding incident, pulled over, and no other suspension from that. But, you know, there were some issues there that Todd Bowles had to deal with. So he's not even playing for this team right now. Second down and 10. Bradford, that's time. Now he's being chased and finds a man wide open. It's a tight end, Ertz. And Ertz into Jet territory, down to the 44-yard line.
You've got to hand it to this Philadelphia offensive line because Sam Bradford has been clean the entire game. You see the stunts playing well together. Sam Bradford extends the play and finds Zach Ertz wide open in the middle of the field. Nice execution all the way around for the Philadelphia offense.
So Ertz with a big play, picks up 21. First and 10, Philadelphia. They put it at the 43. This is Sproles. And Sproles hit by DeMario Davis for a short gain.
Yeah, you know, something interesting, Kevin, I think, you know, we saw that first drive, the pace. They got it going. They got that first down, and they were rolling. The pace seems to have slowed down, and if I'm Sam Bradford, I'm pushing it because that's when you had success, that first drive of the game, pushing the pace and tiring this Jets defense.
Second and 7, over the middle, and he's got a completion, and that's going to be Matthews who makes the grab. That's his third catch today, and it'll be a third and short.
That's something Sam Bradford, when we talked to him, he was cognizant of. Look, this Jets defense is multiple. They do a lot. I can't let that slow us down. We got to play our game, and here comes the pace.
Third and 2. They give it to Sproles, right side. Burst through. Sproles still going. Slips, gets back up, and he's got a first down. Well, Sproles has made his mark on this game, and he picks up 12 to move the chains.
Well, nice job by Bradford. You see the pace. The Jets still getting a line. He snaps the ball. That creates the crease, and Darren Sproles continues to play big for the Philadelphia Eagles.
And now Sproles lines up as a wide receiver out at the bottom of your screen. From the 23 on first down. A lot of time. Now Bradford going to dump it off, incomplete. He almost walked into the rush that time. It was blocked up, and it'll be a second down.
And you say, where's this vaunted New York Jets defensive line? That's one thing the Eagles do when they start to go on these long series. No huddle. These defensive linemen start blowing. You see a lot of hand on your hips, on the hips from the New York Jets defensive linemen. They're sucking air.
Eighth play of the drive. Three-man rush. Bradford lets it fly. Matthews has it. Touchdown.
And Chip Kelly says, we had it once. We dropped it. We're going to come back to it, see if they can cover it. And they can't. Ryan Matthews out of the backfield. This is a wheel route. DeMario Davis, get your eyes on your target. Instead, he's looking at the quarterback. There comes the separation. You can't throw it any better if you're Sam Bradford.
Now, he led Matthews perfectly. A 23-yard touchdown pass. An 8-play, 75-yard drive. And Parkey's extra point is up and good. Well, for a team that hadn't scored a single touchdown in the first half this year, they've got 17 on the board here at MetLife Stadium. 17-0, Eagles, Bradford, high fives. I'd say the narrative has changed. As putrid as it was in the first half against Dallas, they haven't been ultra consistent, but they've had a couple great drives Philadelphia has today.
Well, they sure have. And, you know, this is it's an old story in the NFL. When your backs are against the wall, they're injured. DeMarco Murray's not playing. Their two linebackers are out. Teams have a way of galvanizing and playing together, and that's certainly what they're doing. They're taking it to the New York Jets right about
now. They are. It's 17-0, and the Jets need something. Stacy's going to try and give it to him and take this out. Across the 20. Stacy, good return. He bounces out near the 28.
Well, you're going to see the wheel route again. And DeMario Davis in coverage, but watch his eyes. He's looking back at Sam Bradford for some reason. When he's doing that, Ryan Matthews is just running. The separation occurs, and Sam Bradford finds the open Ryan Matthews. Chip Kelly told us, look, he was all positive on Sam Bradford.
He was.
Without a whole lot of good things happening in the 2 weeks of the season, but he had nothing but positive things to say. He really believes in him, and Sam Bradford showing us why.
Jets have to get Brandon Marshall going. He's got two catches from minus 6 yards so far. Jets have one first down as a team with 4:52 to go in the half. Fitzpatrick over the middle. There is Marshall wide open. Drops the ball. Eagles pick it up. They've got the turnover. Marshall had it, was wide open, and then just dropped it, and Jordan Hicks, the rookie, picked it up, and Philadelphia in business.
He didn't drop it, he tried to pitch it. Brandon Marshall with a tremendous play. They move him to the slot, and watch at the end of this play, he sees his teammate and tries to pitch it, just senseless by Brandon Marshall. We'll see if he's down. He is not down and gets rid of that ball. Unbelievable. Finally get him involved. He's trying to make something happen, but you just can't do that. Let's look at that left elbow, see if it's down prior to him pitching it. It's very, very close, Kevin.
Recovered by Philadelphia.
You know, let's see. Ooh, it's close, John.
Really close. Remember, ruled a fumble on the field. So
they look at every turnover automatically upstairs. So it's being looked at right now. And down. Man, that's a hard decision. Now remember,
really,
you have to have indisputable evidence to overturn it. Oof.
The previous play will be reviewed.
Let's go to LA and bring in Mike Pereira. And thankfully, John, we don't have to make this call. But, Mike, if you were making the call, what do you say here?
Well, I don't want to make the call. You make the call.
I mean, it's... I can't.
It's one of those, to me, that is so close. I actually think that he's on the ground, that left forearm gets to the ground before the ball just gets out of his hand. But I like that notion of indisputable. You see it there? Is the hand still on the ball? I think it is. But now, if you're the people looking at the ball, and remember this play, remember it's New York, and it is there at the stadium, you know, to me the hand's still on the ball, but is it going to be enough? I think I'd probably overturn it, to tell you the truth.
All right, Mike, that's a good description. And John, the more we look at it, I think he's down too. It's really close.
I think the key word, though, I think, and you know, when Mike's saying I think, and the tendency has been since they've started to go to New York that if it's anywhere close and not indisputable, they keep the ruling on the field. Although right there, that look is fairly convincing. Left elbow down, that hand still on the ball. But nonetheless, still not a smart play by Brandon Marshall. I know Brandon Marshall. I played with him in Denver. He wants every play to be a touchdown, but you just have to be smart.
Well, as we're saying, I don't know if any of these are definitive, but we'll see. If the Jets keep it, it's by the grace of Marshall's gloves being sticky enough to hold the ball for a split second. All right, here we go. Here's Sturatore.
After review, the ruling on the field stands. The backer pass recovered by Philadelphia. First down.
I don't think you can argue either way. Really don't.
I mean, that's really been the history since we've started this new system of going to New York. Unless it's clearly opposite of what happened or what was called on the field, they've tended to keep the call on the field.
Well, now because of that decision, you know, instead of the Jets having a little momentum and doing something positive on offense, the Eagles can really, really salt this first half away. It's 17-0, and look where this started. Bradford, time again, steps up, throws low. He had a man, Aguilar, and he underthrew him.
Kevin, you mentioned again the protection. All day long, Sam Bradford, a nice wide pocket, the ability to step up in the pocket. And that's a ball that Sam Bradford should complete. Look at that pocket, just like you want it. All kinds of room to step up, and an errant throw by Bradford.
Fourth and 4:33 to go in the half on a second and 10. Four-man rush. Again, it's blocked up. Sproles tackled immediately and then slammed down. That's going to be a penalty by DeMario Davis.
It's been a point of emphasis the last couple of years, not slamming players to the ground, and DeMario Davis does it to Sproles.
I know it's been a point of emphasis, and it's absolutely...
After the runner's forward progress was stopped, you have that necessary roughness. Defense, number 56, 15-yard penalty, automatic, first down.
I was saying it's absolutely a penalty, but as a former hard-hitting safety...
It makes me sick. It really does. I mean, it's football. I think there's ones that are obvious where the player could restrain himself. That, to me, was in the act of making the tackle. But that's how they've been calling it
yes.
The last couple of years.
No, by the book, it's absolutely a penalty. But that's tough for Davis, man. You got a guy that's so, slithery. He's hard to bring down. And now, bottom line is Philadelphia, first and 10 of the Jet 21. Up 17. Give it to Sproles. And short gain by Sproles.
Well, you look at it at regular speed. DeMario Davis, remember, he's tackling Darren Sproles. Tough guy to tackle. Does he put a little extra oomph on it? Absolutely. But remember, this is football, not tiddlywinks. I mean, we're playing ball here, and it does make me sick. I'm getting hot up here right now, but those are the rules. That's why it was fun quite often, though.
John, don't take it out on me. You hit very hard. I'd like to stay for the rest of the game. Second and 7. Matthews on the stretch left. Good seam. Ryan Matthews, first down, and he's inside the 10. And a first and goal for Philadelphia coming up.
Really impressed with this Philadelphia offensive line. You see Barber make the block on Leonard Williams, the first round pick, and this much maligned offensive line for Philly really doing a nice job today against a tough front.
There's the offensive line. Kelsey, the Pro Bowl center, who had an off week last week, coming to Matthews' right side, looking for room, patient inside the 5.
Lane Johnson, the right tackle, and that's just beautiful blocking. He's moving it himself to get the block down, and Revis at the end of this play, Darrell Revis comes up a little lame. I think he gets kicked by DeMario Davis.
Revis is in there, though. Bottom of your screen, Bradford rolling right. Pressure, throws, looking for the end zone. Matthews, he's tackled by screen, just shy. Matthews thought he was in. They're going to mark him down short.
One thing you have with Buster Screen, a player that's going to fight on every play. You see his right shoulder down, right elbow down. Good call, marking it just short of the goal line.
Eagles hustling, third and goal. Sproles up the middle, and he is in. Touchdown. And the Eagles are laying the wood to the Jets here in this first half.
Kevin, you remember the old axiom in football, low man wins. Well, there's a perfect example. Darren Sproles at 5'6" almost just hides underneath the Jets tacklers and finds his way into the end zone.
There's an injured Eagle on the play. Tried to get off. Andrew Gardner, the right guard, and then he went down to one knee.
Here's what we're talking, low man wins. Watch Sproles just get even smaller than that 5'6" frame and just go right under the Jets defense. But again, the offensive line getting nice push.
John, especially, we always talk about Eagles and tempo, right? But especially on that particular play, third and goal from, the half-yard line, the Jets had no chance to get set. How tough is that for a defense in that spot?
It's tough, and it's the challenge. You can't simulate it in practice. You try to, but you don't know their playbook. So scout team, you need cards and all that. As much as you try, you can't simulate it. And that's the challenge that the Eagles present. Now, the problem the first couple games, they've been going backwards. And so
right.
They haven't had the first downs to let that pace wear on the opposing team.
Still looking at Andrew Gardner, the right guard. There's Marshall. This all drive because of Marshall. Had a great catch coming across the middle and decided a crazy lateral as he was going to the ground. And the Eagles capitalized with a 7-play, 36-yard drive. This fall, Fox brings you an hour of all-star comedy. We've got Grandfathered with John Stamos and Josh Peck, and The Grinder with Rob Lowe and Fred Savage. The fall's funniest premieres this Tuesday on Fox. Gardner now walking off under his own power. That's good news. The starting right guard for the Eagles. His right guards were under siege in Philadelphia this week for the performance against the Cowboys. But obviously, this first half has been much different. Parkey for the extra point try. And it's good. So first it was Marshall trying to make something happen. It went backwards. Hicks recovered it. And then Bradford and Sproles and company put it home. And it's 24-0. Eagles over the Jets. This is coming into today, just as a reminder if you just tuned in, okay? This is what the Eagles were their first halves in the first two games of the year. They were terrible. Today, much different. They've gotten contributions from all over the place as an idea. Give you a little idea. They had 70 total rushing yards in their first two games. John, they've got 87 this first half. And they've got a 24-0 lead over the Jets. Here's Zach Stacy running near side out across the 20. But the Jets have 2:06 to go and two timeouts to get something positive on offense.
Kevin, you talk about contributions. You know, I think who deserves a lot of credit for this Philly first half? The Pope, Pope Francis. It's been so negative in Philadelphia. Pope Francis is in Philadelphia right now. They left on Thursday. They got out of there. They bonded as a team. I talked to a couple of the players. It may have been the best thing for them, they thought, and sure enough. So Pope Francis must be an Eagles fan.
So the Pope gave the Mets the NL East, but they can't give the Jets who went on the same day. Is that what you're telling me? First and 10 for the Jets at the 21. Again, two timeouts to go, and they got the two-minute warning. Fitzpatrick over the middle. Manuwa makes a catch, short game. And that'll take us down to the two-minute warning. Sam Bradford, he's had a good day. So is this Eagles offense. They're up big. Get apps, videos, and more at itunes.com/NFL. 24-0 Philadelphia. Jets have the ball on their own 27. 2 minutes to go in the first half. They've got two timeouts to their credit, and they've done nothing on offense all day long. Here's Bilal Powell up the middle, first down. And the Jets see if they move with some alacrity here. And we were telling you last time, trying to get Brandon Marshall going, and then they finally get him the ball, and he picks up 15 and then throws it away on a crazy lateral. He's on the bottom of your screen. Byron Maxwell lays off in the coverage. We haven't called Maxwell's name. He's had a tough first couple weeks, not today. Powell dragged down by Vinny Curry. And the clock is running. Jets not taking a timeout here.
Kevin, you know, I think one of the keys moving into the second half at the end of this first half, they're going to have to move Brandon Marshall around. Without Decker, they're doubling him on almost every play.
It's Patrick over the middle, and Newman, good adjustment, and a heck of a catch, and he gets up, and I guess he was not down. He's inside the 40 now, the 39. Jets have to call a timeout, don't they?
Great play by Anunua. You see the throw back behind him. He reaches back, and then the presence of mind to get up as he's untagged and get more positive yards.
They choose not to call a timeout. Still two in their pocket. Fitzpatrick in trouble. Down he goes. Now you've got to call a timeout. Vinny Curry got big-time pressure there. And Barwin was there as well.
Connor Barwin, 14.5 sacks. You watch the two Philly defensive linemen up front. They just push the offensive line right in to Ryan Fitzpatrick, and it's Barwin who reaches out to bring down Ryan Fitzpatrick, a ball that really Fitzpatrick has to throw away.
So Fitzpatrick and the Jets now with 45 seconds left. Willie Colon Looked like he was walking a little gingerly. The right guard for the Jets, 66 after that play. He did not come out of the game. That's a Nunwa in motion. Eagles showing blitz. It's Patrick, far side. He's got a completion over there. And that's going to be Devin Smith, the rookie, with his first NFL grab. But the Jets not calling timeout. Time ticking down, wasting away. Now 30 seconds to go in the half. And a third down to boot. Four-man rush. Fitzpatrick slinging it near side. There's Marshall. He's got the catch. First down, but he did not get out of bounds. And the Jets have to burn their final timeout here.
Well, that's what Brandon Marshall does. He made the bonehead play, no doubt about it. But one thing this guy can do is beat one-on-one coverage. And that's one of his favorite routes. The stop fade can essentially initiate contact. Ryan Fitzpatrick going to throw it behind Brandon Marshall on purpose, with a purpose. And Brandon Marshall reaches back. You see, it takes a lot of trust, does this route. And Brandon Marshall, his physicality allows him to be so good at that particular route.
Couple things. Obviously, momentum-wise, it would be huge if the Jets can get a touchdown here to somewhat get back in the game. Two, remember, Jets had a really bad challenge on a play that never looked like it was close. And so because of that, they're out of timeouts right now. 17 seconds to go in the half. No timeouts. From the Eagles, 16. Fitzpatrick steps away from pressure, fires end zone wide open. He had Smith, but he totally missed him.
Boy, did he have Devin Smith. He stepped up in the pocket. He saw the open lane. Ryan Fitzpatrick steps up. Here's Devin Smith and just throws it behind him. Poor throw by Ryan Fitzpatrick.
And so now 12 seconds left, and again, no timeouts. So,
sorry, Kevin, wherever Brandon Marshall's going, Connor Barwin going to get some hands on him, paying special attention to him.
Fitzpatrick in trouble, gets away, throws in. It's caught, and it's a touchdown. Brandon Marshall making amends, and the Jets are on the board with 6 seconds to go in the half.
Wasn't the prettiest of drives, but they stuck with it. And when in doubt, throw it to 15. Brandon Marshall getting all kinds of attention on top. Connor Barwin underneath. But Ryan Fitzpatrick threads the needle.
John, it wasn't always a pretty drive, but they got it done. And the Jets needed that. And that's quite a difference going in the locker room, 24-0 as opposed to 24-7, now with a little something on offense.
Gives them a little momentum coming into the second half. And, you know, you see Connor Barwin giving special attention, getting hands on him. Malcolm Jenkins all over him, but you just need a little space with Brandon Marshall. Such good hands, such good body control. Ryan Fitzpatrick comes back after a missed throw for a touchdown and finds Brandon Marshall.
Looked like Fitzpatrick, to his credit, put that in the right spot, too, with Jenkins, who slipped a little bit, kind of only spot that Marshall could catch it.
No doubt about it. And remember, you know, Brandon Marshall out there, he's their one receiver. They're 2 and 3 in Eric Decker and Chris Owusu, not playing today. Mm-hmm. So some struggles were maybe to be anticipated, particularly if you get behind.
Kurt, Terry, Howie, Michael, and Jimmy coming up at the half with all the scores and the highlights. We will get you there in 6 seconds. And the other thing is, even though Chris Ivory was active, we were told he's going to play with the quad and the groin injury, he hasn't played a snap. So clearly something happened late. So Jets are without a lot on offense. And now Folk will kick it away with 6 seconds to go in the half. Barner's going to pick it up for the Eagles, and he's upended with 2 seconds to go in the half by Aaron Henderson. Brandon Marshall, after that crazy lateral that led to an Eagle touchdown, big on that drive with a couple big catches, including, of course, the 16-yard touchdown.
He's a great football player, and he's going to come back, and he's going to continue to compete. Sometimes that's what gets in Brandon Marshall's way. He wants every play to be a touchdown, and sometimes you got to take what you can get and go to the next play.
Eagles will just take a knee and be content going to the break with a 24-7 halftime lead. Eagles have been in control, but the Jets do get on the board, get some sort of momentum. Darren Sproles has been the star. Rushing touchdown and 89-yard punt return. He has been everywhere for Philadelphia, playing this game without DeMarco Murray. Brandon Marshall, though, gets him on the board with 6 seconds to go on the half, hauling in that 16-yarder. And so that's where we stand from MetLife Stadium in New Jersey. With the Eagles up on the Jets, 24-7. Eagles will get the football to start the third quarter. A lot of highlights to get to, including the big game in Dallas between the Cowboys and the Falcons. We'll do that coming up next. Eagles lead the Jets here in New Jersey. Halftime and the fellas from L.A. heading there now. Today's excitement is brought to you by Nissan. Today's excitement brought to you by Nissan. It's 24-7. Eagles over the Jets as we get set for the third quarter. Jets at least got a little momentum with the touchdown late to Brandon Marshall, John Lynch, Kevin Burkhardt, and now the Jets will be tested. They haven't really been. They've been ahead. They've been in control. Now they've got a big hill to climb.
Yeah, you're right. This is uncharted territory for Ryan Fitzpatrick and this Jets offense. How are they going to respond? And remember, two of their top three receivers, Eric Decker and Chris Owusu, out. So they're going to have to find some production from somebody, because Brandon Marshall's getting doubled all over the field. So yeah, tough to do, but Darren Sproles has been the story of this game for the Philadelphia Eagles.
Yeah, he really has. I mean, DeMarco Murray out, so he hasn't played. So Matthews has played well, and then Sproles has done everything. The special teams touchdown, 89-yard punt return. He had a great block. He had the running touchdown. And, you know, the Eagles finally had a first half that's worth mentioning, because the first two first halves were pretty rough for them. Three total points in the first half, coming in 24 in this first half here.
Kevin, I think the important thing, if you're the Eagles, continue to push that pace. Continue up front. They're playing well on the offensive line.
Here's Kenyon Barner, who will take a knee. And we go down the sidelines with Pam Oliver.
Hey there, Kevin. I was talking to Todd Bowles at the half, and he said, we cannot turn over the ball offensively. Ironically, wide receiver Brandon Marshall walked past me, and he said that lateral was the worst play in NFL history. Bowles, meantime, said, we've got to tackle better. We're good at the point of impact, but we're letting guys squeak out. For the Eagles, Chip Kelly, happy about that run game. Sam Bradford picking it up. He said, we feed off that. Back to you.
Well, Pam, at least Brandon Marshall has a sense of humor.
I think he's right.
All right, so Philadelphia football. They're up 24-7 as we start the third quarter. Here's Bradford to throw it. Looking deep near side. Matthews incomplete. We get a flag. Buster Screen was on the coverage. Now let's see what the penalty's about.
Pass interference. Defense number 41. Spot of the foul, automatic. First down.
Good tight coverage from Buster Screen. But they're going to get him for that arm lock. You see he has a hold of Jordan Matthews' left arm. Good call by the official. Tight coverage, but when you're holding and restricting that arm, the official's right on top of it.
It's an 18-yard penalty, and so first down for Bradford and company. All kinds of time, and a little comeback to Matthews. Good speed by Jordan Matthews, and he's out across the 48 for a 10-yard gain and a first down. That's the new right guard for the Eagles, Matt Tobin. Andrew Gardner went out late in the first half. He's got a foot injury. Eagles say he will not return.
And Kevin, if you've watched Todd Bowles over the years as a defensive coordinator, both at Miami and in Arizona, he's a pressure guy. Well, part of the feeling is with this front, maybe I didn't need to blitz. He needs to blitz, because they are not getting there. Sam Bradford having all day to throw the football.
Come near side to Sproles. Cuts back for no gain. Well, it's interesting. This offensive line for the Eagles was obviously criticized for their performance the last week and the last 2 weeks, really. And, you know, we got a chance to sit with Jason Peters, and he said, hey, we looked at the tape last week, and Dallas did exactly what we were trying to do. So what did the Eagles try to do?
Well, today they've gone back to the basics. Let's get off the ball. Let's move quickly. And let's do some things like run the football downhill as opposed to sideways. They're doing it and doing it well.
Penalty flag as Bradford sacked for the first time. Wilkerson and Williams were there, but let's see what the penalty is.
Illegal formation. Offense number 65 was not on the line of scrimmage. That penalty is declined. Third down.
This is one that they've been calling more across the league, and you see how far he's back. If you break the hip line of the center, you're usually all right. Lane Johnson trying to get a little room by backing up, and they catch him on it.
And because of that, a third down and 20.
Stand for the door.
Three-man rush all day. Here's Sproles over the middle. And Sproles can only do so much by himself. Well short of the first down. Out to the 47, and the Eagles will punt it away. But the Jets defense does their job. And now they will send Curley back to receive the punt of Donnie Jones. Here's Jones. High kick, well covered. Curley fair catches around the 12. Well, the Jets defense doing their job. Now can the offense pick it up? 24-7 Eagles here in the third. Jets football down 24-7 early third quarter. Deep in their own territory from the 12 they start. And they're going to fake the run. It's Patrick on the roll. Far side. He's got a completion. There is Devin Smith, the rookie from Ohio State, and Smith has a 16-yard gain.
You know, we spoke about it. Two of their top three receivers out. So who's going to come to the forefront? And Devin Smith, the rookie from Ohio State, asserts himself early in the second half, getting separation from Byron Maxwell. Nicely thrown football by Ryan Fitzpatrick.
And his second catch today. First game being active of his NFL career. This time Smith to the bottom of your screen. Brandon Marshall on top. First and 10. Powell coming near side and nowhere to go. Walter Thurman from safety came right up and eradicated that play.
You know, they really miss the downhill style of Chris Ivory, because you see Bilal Powell try to bounce this football. I don't think he needs to. The crease is right in front of him. Instead, he tries to bounce. Fletcher Cox does a tremendous job, as does Walter Thurman coming up to finish the tackle.
John, first two games, Jets were 127 yards a game rushing, 10th in the league. Today, without Ivory, now they've got just 22 rushing yards. Barwin coming on pressure. Fitzpatrick, good throw. There's Marshall, and he's got a first down for the Jets. Out to the 43-yard line, and it's a gain of 16.
Well, that's a great job by Ryan Fitzpatrick. This is eye manipulation at its finest. He's going to look out to Bilal Powell in the flat. You see him, he's looking at Bilal Powell. That draws the coverage off Marshall and then throws it downfield. Really nice job by Ryan Fitzpatrick.
Powell picks up the blitz. Fitzpatrick hit, strip, it's loose on the ground. And whistle blows, they say incomplete. Good thing for the Jets, that would have been a touchdown for Fletcher Cox.
It's going to be Brandon Bear who comes in and hits him, and that hand is coming forward. It's batted down. Nice pressure by Brandon Bear and that Eagles front.
And that is the right call. Willie Colon, the right guard, out for the Jets this year. John, Brian Winters in. We saw Colon limping a little bit the last series of the half. Here's Fitzpatrick. Over the middle, just got away from him. I don't know if he has got his hand hit, but that was way overthrown, and a third and 10 coming.
Well, something that Chan Gailey's done a nice job of with Ryan Fitzpatrick. He knows Ryan Fitzpatrick. You've seen a lot this year. The ball out of his hand very quickly. Today's game, you fall behind, you maybe have to push the ball downfield. That's where Ryan Fitzpatrick throughout his career has been susceptible to throwing interceptions.
Jets are 2 of 8 on third down today against this Philly D. This is 3rd and 10. Blitz coming. Picked up. Fitzpatrick going deep for Smith. Incomplete. Eric Rowe, the rookie from Utah, had good coverage, and the Jets will have to punt.
First of all, beautiful protection by Bilal Powell to allow Fitzpatrick to have the throw, but just excellent coverage by the rookie from Utah. Turning and locating the football at the last moment. No panic by Eric Rowe. It's a guy they were very high on, hasn't played much, but he steps up when they need him.
Another punt. Eagles got close, but quickly got it off. Another gem. Scrolls all the way out to the 10, and he catches it going out of bounds. Good play by the Eagles rookie Eric Rowe, Philadelphia football, and their lead. Brandon Marshall trying to get this Jets offense going. They had one drive before the half. That's been it. And they trail by 17 early third quarter. Philly football from their own 10. Bradford back in action from the gun. They'll throw it quickly. Far side Jordan Matthews making people miss. And he's to the 15 for a gain of 5. Bradford has had a lot of time to throw the ball today. Jets had 3 sacks coming in and pressure, but not much today on Bradford. Is it a clean pocket by this Eagles offensive line? 2nd and 5. Blitz coming and way overthrowing Matthews in a 3rd down.
We're starting to see the Jets. We saw glimpses of it. What the Eagles did, they kept this defensive front on the field and tired them. But on this first 2 plays, you're starting to see this defensive front of the Jets assert themselves again. We'll see if they can on 3rd down.
Jason Peters, their all-pro left tackle, nicked on that last play. Third down 5, blitz coming over the middle, incomplete. Antonio Cromartie may have run a better pattern than Miles Austin that time, and the Jets force a 3 and out.
Well, Todd Bowles, we were calling on him to start bringing pressure. That's exactly what he does. Watch him bring the extra bodies. And why can you do that? Because you have such a talented secondary with Darrell Revis, Antonio Cromartie, Buster Screen. You've got guys who can cover man-to-man, thus you can send the pressure.
Jones with a punt, a spiraling rocket, but returnable. Curley across the 40, 45 to midfield. Jeremy Curley, he's had some good returns today. That one for 18 yards. Jets have good field position. Down 24-7 in the third. Jets football, good field position after Jeremy Curley's punt return. At the Eagle 45, 10-13 to go in the third. They trail by 17. Fitzpatrick, a delayed draw. Boy, that looked awkward, but Powell somehow able to get almost 5 yards. This season, you could stream live local Sunday afternoon games right on your smartphone with NFL Mobile. Talked a lot with Philly about Byron Maxwell and the big money contract that he spent or that he got. First 2 games he was picked on quite a bit. Now he's on the top of your screen. He's been quiet today, and that's a good thing, and now we get movement. Barwin jumped. Question is, was he drawn off sides?
Nice hard count by Ryan Fitzpatrick, something he's done particularly well this year from the gun. And you see Barwin saying, hey, you know, he's moving, but Connor Barwin, I don't think, is going to get his way.
Neutral zone infraction. Defense, number 98, 5-yard penalty, still second down.
Let's get a quick game break with Kurt Menefee.
Well, the matchup of unbeaten's proven to be the game of the day so far. Atlanta coming back. Julio Jones, 45-yard touchdown reception. He's over 100 on the day. It's 28-25 after the two-point conversion, Kevin.
He is unbelievable. Good game there. Jets trying to make this a game here. Second down and one. Fake to Powell. Time. Fitzpatrick going deep. Down the field. Knocked away. Nolan Carroll had tremendous coverage on Marshall.
Well, first of all, I love the call. Second and one, you don't get it, so what? You come back, it's third and one. I like the aggressiveness. I even like better that coverage by Nolan Carroll. Might he have had his left arm on Marshall's left arm? Yes, he does, but tremendous play by Nolan Carroll, locating the football, getting his hand on it, fighting Brandon Marshall. Really tough to do in man-to-man coverage.
Here's where the Jets would love to have Chris Ivory, who hasn't played a snap today. They're big back. They go with Powell on a third and short, and they sneak, and it works beautifully. Fitzpatrick's going to pick up almost 4 yards. There's Nick Mangold, the center for the Jets, six-time Pro Bowler. And now the Jets looking to hurry it up a little bit. Turn the tide on the Eagles.
Hey, Mike, no, he knew Mike. 58 to Mike.
Eagles, we told you, without three starters today on D.
Hey, Mike's 59.
Blitz coming. It's picked up. Fitzpatrick runs into one, gets rid of it to Powell. That was a lot for nothing. He gets maybe a yard.
Yeah, Bilal Powell says, that's really nice. You give it to me, let me get hit. But Fitzpatrick, they do a nice job picking up the blitz, but just nothing downfield. So he's going to flip it with his left hand, pull his Brett Favre imitation. And Bilal Powell gets swarmed by the Philly defense.
Yeah, you heard it there, but Fitzpatrick, about his cadence, told us, you want to use it as a weapon. You got Barwin to jump off sides before, and you heard it there. It's tricky. Second down. Back to throw. Powell, good catch on a high throw. And then chucks forward to the 30. So a third and a manageable four.
That's a nice finish by Bilal Powell. Looked like it was going to be a third and long, and just pure will carrying guys, making it a much more manageable third down situation.
And so a third down and five. Jets in field goal range already, but obviously down 17. They'd love to have more. Empty set, four-man rush, going deep again, looking for the rookie, Smith, and it is intercepted! Eric Rowe, the rookie, his second great play, and he picks it off for his first NFL interception. And hang on, a flag, far side of the field of the line of scrimmage. Brandon Marshall high-fiving his teammates like it's on the Eagles.
Illegal formation, offense, number 68, was uncovered. That penalty is declined. The result of the play is an interception in the end zone. Touchback. First down, Philadelphia.
Well, you've got rookie on rookie. Devin Smith, pure speed. Eric Rowe, we saw him stand up earlier. Again, tremendous job. Turning his head, no panic. Locate the football. Brings in the interception. You can't do any better, Eric Rowe. Two rookies going at it. The one for the Philadelphia Eagles. Eric Rowe wins out.
You know, John, it's thing is fascinating about this story. The Eagles go out and draft Rowe. He's, you know, one of their Chip Kelly guys, a big, tall cornerback. He likes speed, he likes size, right? So they go and get him from Utah, but he's been really low on the totem pole. I mean, he's barely played, and then he comes in because the Jets run all these empty sets with five wide. He's playing today, and now he makes two great plays and his first NFL interception. He just sucks the momentum out of the Jets. Here's Ryan Matthews running left. Not much there. David Harris helped string them out. Well, the Jets coming into today were the best in the NFL, plus 8. They had 10 turnovers, which led the league. Today, They don't have any, but they've given it away twice.
I think the other thing, by getting this lead, what they've done is make Ryan Fitzpatrick get out of his comfort zone, which is the short, quick throws. Now he's having to try to get the ball downfield, and that's where the turnovers are happening.
Second down and 8. Matthews still in the game at tailback. He'll get it. And the Jets stack him up right away. David Harris on the first tackle. And so a third down coming up for Philadelphia. And so Sproles comes in. Jets defense trying to keep them in it here. Philly's got the punt return. They've had a couple real nice drives, but they haven't been consistent throughout. Third down and 8 here. Blitz. Bradford throws it for Sproles. Oh, he dropped it! As great as Sproles has been, he had a touchdown.
Well, Sam Bradford located the exact matchup he wanted. Sproles on David Harris. Kevin, you said it. He's been so good. Same wheel route that they've found success with in the first half. Beautiful throw by Sam Bradford. Sproles just drops it.
Eagles have had a couple of those today dropped. Here's Curley. He's had a good day returning the punts. And gets decked at the 30. Jets defense does their job. They force a 3-and-out. Todd Bowles not loving what he sees. His team down 17 in the third. Well, the Eagles wasted an opportunity. Sam Bradford threw a perfect pass. The Sproles dropped. Could have been a touch. The Eagles have two running backs drop wheel routes that could have gone to the house. But they still have a 17-point lead. And so Ryan Fitzpatrick takes over for the Jets on their own 30. Zach Stacy in the game at running back, number 30. Fitzpatrick sets it up to Stacy, and that had no chance. Brandon Graham all over it. And Stacy's going to lose 5.
Eagles playing really good fundamental football. When a team's trying to screen, what's important is that you go get them. Watch Brandon Graham go get Zach Stacy, not let the play develop. Nothing there for the Jets. Brandon Graham has done that twice today. Eagles playing really nice fundamental football, doing the little things well.
So a 2nd and 15 now for Fitzpatrick and company. They move Smith with the play clock already at 4. Gets it off. 4-man rush, and Fitzpatrick just lost it. Incomplete.
Talked about uncharted territory, Kevin. This is a team that's played with leads in their 2 previous wins. They're not playing with leads. They're behind. Fitzpatrick a little bit out of his comfort zone, and this Philadelphia Eagles defense doing a really nice job, led by Billy Davis, the defensive coordinator.
And we always talk about the snaps and the amount of time the Eagles defense is on the field, and they don't probably get enough due because they're pretty good. Bill Davis said, hey, look at it this way. You usually have about 12 drives to defend a game. We had 12 drives last week against Dallas. It is what it is. Fitzpatrick under pressure. Here's Curley set up. Nice move, but absolutely nowhere to go for Jeremy Curley. And the Jets go backwards, and the fans let them hear it.
You know, fascinating player to watch on this defense, that guy right there, Connor Barwin. We see him doing so much. 14 and a half sacks last year. Right here, he rushes, but then watch him turn and run to the football, getting in on the tackle. He talks about it all the time. At the end of the play, I want to be next to the ball, and that's what he is. He's all over the field for the Philly defense.
Quigley had a great day punting, despite the fact Sproles took one back before. And he gets another gem, and the Eagles, after a fair catch, will take over right around the 30-yard line. They're in control. Philadelphia 24, New York 7, 4:23 to go in the third. Eagles in control here at MetLife Stadium in northern New Jersey, and they've got the football on their own 30. Chip Kelly, a lot of people this week talking like he forgot how to coach after an 0-2 start. And you know what today is? He's saying not so fast. His Eagles team has looked good. Ryan Matthews coming near side. Good run, Matthews. Looked like he was going to lose yards. Instead, he's going to gain 5.5 on the play.
Ryan Matthews has been very impressive. DeMarco Murray couldn't go. A lot on Ryan Matthews' shoulders, and he's run the football extremely well. There you see him stretch the ball, but then put that foot in the ground and get downhill.
13 carries, 75 yards for Matthews. And think about all the money they gave to DeMarco Murray. They gave Matthews a 3-year, $11 million deal. And that sure looks like a smart move today. Here's Sproles. The other guys had a big day, despite the drop last time. But Davis is there to tackle. And then a third and short is coming up. So how about these Eagles, John? I mean, it couldn't look any worse the first 2 weeks. It's changed today.
Well, they've fixed what's been ailing them. And we said in the pregame before in the open, it would start with running the football. Could they do that effectively? If so, it opens up their pass game. It gets their defense off the field so much. And that plan has worked for them.
94 yards on the ground today. They had 70 the last two combined. Here's Matthews on a third down. That time the run game gets completely stuffed. Calvin Pryor, the safety, came up with a horde of others, and the Eagles will have to punt.
You watch Calvin Pryor get in that backfield. The play before, he sets this up, and watch Calvin Pryor coming from the middle. He's going to penetrate that defense and get in the backfield. Two nice plays by Calvin Pryor.
Another punt from Jones. High kick, deep, curly. We'll try it. And return of only a couple, covered well by Malcolm Jenkins. Not only has he been one of their best defenders, he's down there making the special teams tackle. October means baseball, and FS1 continues to be your home for postseason action with the American League Division and Championship Series. Don't miss a moment of the drama and history. It all begins October 8th on FS1 and streaming live on Fox Sports Go.
Kim, that Mike Trout catch.
Oh,
unbelievable.
Robin a home run last night for the Angels, who have surged into the race. Race in the American League for that wild card is tight, John. Well, the Jets defense trying to do everything they can to allow the Jet offense come back in this game. 2:48 to go in the third. Jets down 17. Here's Fitzpatrick. Throwing far side of the field. And there's Smith, the rookie, again, out for what should be a first down. And it'll be a gain of 11. And that'll move the chains for the Jets. Hey, Ryan Fitzpatrick, this year, intermediate throws under 15 yards, he's been fantastic. When he goes deep, he hasn't been good. That's coming into today. Now, how about today? How's he done? Well, he's thrown a lot more passes deep because they've been down. And you see, passes under 15 yards. Good completion percentage, doing the job. 6 of 13, a pick. That's where he gets into trouble going deep, John.
No doubt about it. And credit to the Philadelphia Eagles for understanding that and putting him in a situation where he needs to throw the football deep.
So first down. Run fake. A lot of time. He's going deep here. They're looking for Smith. Double coverage. And incomplete, simply because the Eagles knocked that out of each other's hands. We've got a game break. Checking in with Kurt Menefee.
Steelers lead on the scoreboard in St. Louis, but this could be a huge loss for them. Ben Roethlisberger hit low by Mark Barron. Left the game with a knee injury. Had to be carted off. So Michael Vick, now in at quarterback for the Steelers, completes a quick pass coming out of the gate. So not so bad. For him, of course, Vic played with both the Eagles and the Jets, and right now trying to hold it together for the Steelers. Kevin?
Wow, that's not good. This was also not a good decision.
Not at all, and there's a reason some guys play DB, some guys play receiver. Norman Carroll right in his mitts.
Jets get a reprieve, and they hand off. Powell's going to pick up about four. Fletcher Cox on the stop, and now a big third down because time's an issue. Under 2 minutes to go in the third, you need 17 points. There's still time left, but you got to get some points here.
Now, this is big, no doubt about it. And what you got to do, I think, is you don't allow Brandon Marshall to be doubled. And how do you do that? You move him all over the field. You motion him. I think in a situation like this, you've got to go to your best player.
Marshall is going to line up in the slot. Near the top of your screen. There he is. Thanks, John. That's a noon line motion on a third and six. Four-man pressure. Fitzpatrick throws. There is Marshall. Takes a hit and hangs on. John, good call. Up to the 48 and a first down and a pickup of 14.
Well, you see him in that slot. Real hard to double someone in the slot. They go to the zone principle. Maxwell makes him pay, but he moves the chains. The important thing for the Jets.
So the Jets keep on going with 50 seconds to go in the third quarter. Marshall took a hard shot. He'll sit out of play. Zach Stacy in at running back, but he lines up as a slot receiver. Top of your screen.
Keep it tight, though.
Fitzpatrick, near side, in and out of the hands of Cumberland, the tight end. And so a second down and 10 coming up. Fitzpatrick, 24 of 38, 183 yards, a touchdown, and an interception. But the Jets, other than the fact the turnovers, which were a huge story the first 2 weeks, nothing today. They can't run the ball. Chris Ivory out has been a huge factor.
Well, he's a game-changing type player. You know, part of what Chris Ivory brings as well, the style he runs with, it's contagious. It gets people playing physical because he's so physical in running the football.
They have 36 rushing yards. They came in averaging 100 more just about per game. Second and 10 here. It's Patrick in trouble. Four-man rush gets to him. He escapes. Now he's going to just run for his life, and he's going to pick up some positive yards. He'll run the clock. At least it makes it a more reasonable third down. That may take us to the end of the third quarter. It'll be a third down and 5 as we get set to start the fourth quarter. So the Jets have a lot of work to do. Their football, they're down 17 as we head to the fourth. Eagles defense has been up to the task today. Well, the Jets have the football, but they got a lot of ground to make up. They've got a full quarter to do it as we start the fourth. And a huge third down here. Third and 5 from the Philadelphia 47. Ryan Fitzpatrick has Bilal Powell back with him. Brandon Marshall, bottom of your screen. Near side, Marshall incomplete, and we got a penalty flag. Going to get a flag here. Maxwell was on the coverage.
Prior to the pass, holding defense, number 31. 5-yard penalty, automatic. First down.
And it's not the pass interference. They call a hold on Byron Maxwell. And Brandon Marshall not having kind words for Byron Maxwell. Byron Maxwell, I think he's playing more like the guy they went out and signed. Mm. You've seen him more up in people's face. I'll take that penalty because he's up doing what he does best, pressing the wide receivers.
But it's a big conversion. It gives the Jets a first at the Philly 42. They run it. Powell, right side, and just fights his way for 3. That looked like it had nothing much. But he did get a couple before Benny Logan brought him down. You know, Maxwell, they gave him $63 million, John. And I asked Bill Davis, the defensive coordinator for the Eagles, hey, going from that number 2 quarterback to that number 1, is it a big deal? And he said,
it's enormous. Because you start covering people like Brandon Marshall instead of the number 2 guy. And that's a huge difference in this league. There's that matchup right here.
See if Fitzpatrick looks that way on a 2nd and 7. Got a good pocket, throws far side, low throw, good recovery by Cumberland, has to get up and stumbles his way forward. He's going to be about a yard shy of a first down, a good throw, and he had the first.
Tell you one thing I've been impressed with throughout today is this Philadelphia defensive front. There's Benny Logan, Connor Barwin, Brandon Graham, Brandon Bear. I mean, you've had 2 guys out, a starter in Cedric Thornton, Taylor Hart out. But they've stepped up, and frankly, they've been the more impressive defensive line today. The Jets, so much hype coming in.
Call it a 3rd and 2. Fitzpatrick thinks about running. He will tackle and roll 4. The spot is big. Question is, where was he down? Brandon Graham on.
Fitzpatrick lunging for that first down. I don't think he's ever down. He's on top of Graham, but here's where he wanted to go, and really nice coverage by Carroll.
Yeah, I'm with you. I think that roll, the fact that he rolled on his back, got him the first. Watch that.
He's never touched the ground. He's on top of Graham, and he swings him forward.
I think it's, well, the mark's everything, but it sure looked from here like he had it if he wasn't down. Oh, this is close. He's got it. Jets can catch a break. And
see him, he's not down there, he's on top of Graham. So Graham's actually throwing him, propelling him to the first down.
Yeah, and it looks like from that angle, great shot that he's got it with the ball. See when the ball hits, it looks like it rolls past that first down marker. So just gets it, but it keeps the drive alive for the Jets. 10th play of this drive. Down 17, Zach Stacy in the backfield. And that time the Kings may have hurt his own team.
False start. Offense number 60. 5-yard penalty. First down.
That's something that can be a weapon, but we've seen it twice today. Hurt the New York Jets, the hard count of Ryan Fitzpatrick. He's got a really good one. It's quite effective, but you got to hold your water if you're on offense.
So a first and 15. Jets split Kellen Davis, backup tight end, to the top of your screen. This formation, Fitzpatrick looking to hit Curley, double pumps and then incomplete. Looked like he was going to go there initially, John, but just didn't throw it and then came back to him.
You really feel number one, Chris Ivory not being there, but then number two, Eric Decker. It's so hard when you really only have one receiver out there. And I think that's all that Fitzpatrick is comfortable with right now. We've seen him try to go to Devin Smith. The last one ended up with an interception. Right now, I think he trusts one wide receiver, and Eric Decker being gone is an absolute huge loss for the New York Jets.
Play clock's already at four here. You got to get this off, and they do. Blitz coming. Fitzpatrick loads over the middle. There's Marshall. Good throw and catch, and a first down. Brandon Marshall down near the 17-yard line. Gain of 20.
They're giving him double coverage. You see Connor Barwin underneath, Nolan Carroll on top, but Ryan Fitzpatrick says, you know what, we're desperate. I need to throw to my best player, and he fits it in.
Marshall, 8 catches, 93 yards, and a touchdown.
Watch Zach Stacy come cross-country, cross the formation to help give that extra second to Ryan Fitzpatrick to deliver that ball.
From the 17, 12th play of the drive for New York. Fitzpatrick, near side, and it's caught by Meanwhile, stretching forward, and gets inside the 10. We've got a game break. Kurt Menefee.
Well, the Cowboys scored in their first two possessions of the game to lead at 14-0. Since then, all Atlanta. Devontae Freeman, 3 touchdowns, 100 yards. Falcons take the lead 32-28 on that one in the fourth quarter. Kevin, John, and Pam.
Is that team playing with Dan Quinn's energy or what?
Unbelievable. We saw it on this field against the Giants last week, down 10 in the fourth quarter. They are a resilient punch.
Jets have taken 6.5 minutes off the clock with this drive. They've got to score a touchdown, down 17. Second and 3 here. That's Curley in motion. Fitzpatrick on a slant. Marshall in trouble. Backs up. And he backed up, but I think he backed out of a first down. We'll see where they put the football. It's going to be a third down and short, I do believe.
Backed up because D'Amico Ryans came a-flying to put a pop on him. D'Amico Ryans has played well, as has Jordan Hicks, instead of Michael Kendricks and Kiko Alonso. See the first down, just turn it forward. Here comes D'Amico Ryans, he backs up, and then the rest of the Eagles' defense comes.
Because of that, a third and one. Fake the run. Fitzpatrick, a keeper, diving forward. And I think he's got it. And he's got it. First and goal for the Jets. Again, the clock a factor now. 10-13 to play. They're down 17.
That's a tough job by Ryan Fitzpatrick. Connor Barwin right where he's supposed to be. You see him get upfield. Now he knows it's going to hurt, but he gets upfield. And plays tough and feels it after that first down.
15th play of drive for the Jets. Back to throw. Looking right. Throwing that way. Marshall can't haul it in. Malcolm Jenkins was right there, and it's incomplete.
I tell you what Malcolm Jenkins is doing. He plays the safety position, but he covers wide receivers. He does it on a regular basis, man-to-man. He's comfortable in that situation, being a college corner. Just enough body presence on Brandon Marshall to distract him. Malcolm Jenkins, one heck of a football player for the Philadelphia Eagles.
Right, 5-8. Right, 20.
On second down. Over the middle. Touchdown, it's Curley. Jets not out of it yet.
And here's the presence of Brandon Marshall, what it does. Watch Malcolm Jenkins. He's going to drive on Brandon Marshall. That opens up the seam for Curley, but that's what a great player does for you. Brandon Marshall doesn't make the touchdown, but really credit Brandon Marshall drawing the attention that opens up the lane.
So now Folk to make it a 10-point lead with 9:37 left. Up and good. Monster drive for the Jets. 16 plays, 81 yards, took 8 minutes and 11 seconds. How about this? The roll gets him the first down. Sometimes you get a little lucky. But Fitzpatrick and the Jets only down 10. Jets aren't out of this game. They're down 10 with 9:37 to go. Just put together a 16-play, 81-yard drive. Curley with the touchdown catch. Guy's been a forgotten man until today with the injuries and its first TD of the year. Fitzpatrick converting a couple big third downs. That helped. And now the Eagles up 10. As the Jets try to find their way back into this game. Curley getting it done. Now it's on to the Jets defense. Darren Sproles back on the field for Philly next. The Jets woke up their fans. They're into it. They're down 10 now. 9:37 to go. Eagles football. They're going to run it to Matthews near side. Good cut. And Matthews sprinting ahead for a first down. John, beginning of the broadcast, I asked you how good this Jets defense could be. And, well, you thought very highly of them, but now is the time.
Yeah, two games is a small body of work. You got to earn the right to be called the best defense in football. Here's a perfect opportunity. Great defenses step up to situations like this. We'll see if the Jets have it in them.
Until that play, the four drives in the second half of Philly had resulted in 21 yards. So their offense has been extremely quiet. But obviously the clock is a factor, too. Under 9 minutes to go. Matthews again, running right. Good seam. Matthews across the 40. And he's near another first down. Ryan Matthews having himself a day as he's got now 95 rushing yards.
And that's not what Jet great defenses do. We see Ryan Matthews twice extend the play to the side, but then put the foot in the ground and have an open area to run downhill unimpeded.
Second and one.
Talk about the clock, Kevin. I like, we talk so much about the pace of the Eagles. Look at them now slowing the clock down. Last time snapped it at 8 seconds. Now they're down. They're going to get it under 5 seconds. Tremendous clock management by Sam Bradford and the Eagles.
Run it again. Why not? And should be enough for a first down. Damon Harrison tackle Matthews. So it's amazing, right? DeMarco Murray, inactive hamstring injury. The Eagles have been absolutely horrific running the football. 70 total yards coming in. And so what do they do today? So far they've got 115 rushing yards.
And credit Ryan Matthews, but don't say, hey, DeMarco Murray, what's wrong with you? Their offensive line has played much better football today, controlling a lot of scrimmage.
Could be the defining drive of this game. Jets obviously have to hold. 7.5 to play. Eagles by 10. First and 10. Matthews again. And Matthews fumbled. It's loose. Penalty flag flies. Who's got the ball? Jets hadn't had a turnover all day. Do they have one here? They do. David Harris made it happen. But there is a penalty. Wait and see.
Number 62. That penalty is
Watch David Harris. He puts his head on the football, and it's DeMario Davis, his counterpart at inside linebacker, who comes up with that fumble. We talk about great defenses stepping up. David Harris says, let me make the play. And that's exactly what he does.
One thing about Ryan Matthews, John, he's had injury issues in his 6 years. That's the 15th time he's fumbled a football in his career. And that couldn't happen at a worse time. And now the Jets down 10, 7:23 to go, all three timeouts. And this crowd is into it, too. What a hit by David Harris.
That's a great play.
Powell is the tailback. Jets go four wide. Protected. Powell's back. Head down for Bilal Powell, and a good effort. He's down to the 30. Gains 11 and a first down.
Good strong running. No panic by the New York Jets. Don't be afraid to check the ball down. Byron Maxwell more interested in stripping the football, but first you have to secure the tackle. That gives Bilal Powell the extra yardage for the first down.
And remember, down 10, they're already in field goal range. Obviously, you'd like more, but they're in Nick Folk's range already. First and 10. Fitzpatrick throwing, Curley almost makes a tremendous play, and incomplete.
Well, two things, an errant throw, but Ryan Fitzpatrick, yes, you have to get the protection right, but they took that time clock all the way down to 6 seconds on the second clock. No urgency by the New York Jets, and not panic situation, but you do have to have a little urgency in the way you operate.
I mean, 6.5 right now, you've got three timeouts, but the way it's going, you're going to put a lot of pressure on your defense to get a three and out. Second and 10. Connor Barwin out on this play for Philadelphia. Their best pass rusher. Blitz picked up. Fitzpatrick tip to the line. Intercepted! The Eagles get it back. It's the rookie who comes through, Jordan Hicks.
Wow. Interesting, Kevin. One of the things that Connor Barwin, who was out that series, told us, Fitzpatrick, a shorter guy. We got to get our hands up. That's exactly what they do. And turnover for Philadelphia Eagles.
The Jets and Eagles join the NFL and all 32 clubs in celebrating Hispanic Heritage Month this year. NFL launching a campaign called Feel the Orgullo, which means feel the pride to celebrate the diversity and rich traditions of Latinos in the NFL and our country. Visit NFL.com/Hispanic Heritage to hear stories about Latino culture from around the league. Eagles after the turnover, the interception by Hicks, the rookie. Give it to Matthews. John, I'll tell you, the Hicks, the rookie, filling in for the injuries with Kendricks out and Alonzo out. He obviously has been great, but how about this guy, Brandon Bear, third-year player from Oregon, 30 years old, two deflections today, seemingly a ton of pressure, too.
Yeah, you know, and we have these boards, Kevin. You can see I got something on everyone. I got nothing on Brandon Bear because, frankly, I've never heard of him, but I've heard of him now. He played himself quite a game.
He got some time last year, had a sack and a half last season. But yeah, he hadn't played this year until today. He's down on the depth chart, but with the injuries to two defensive linemen, he's had quite the impact. Eagles milking the clock. Play clock at two. Matthews will run it again. Short gain for Matthews.
And watch Brandon Bear right here. He's just going to work. If he can't get there, they talked about it. Get your hands up. That's exactly what he does. He tips it. The other replacement, Jordan Hicks, makes the play. This league's all about guys getting their opportunity and making the most of it. Those two young men, Jordan Hicks and Brandon Bear, have done a tremendous job of doing that and picking their team up today.
Third down for Philly. Third and five. Sproles in the game at tailback. Again, milking the clock. Blitz. Bradford going to get it off. Going to let it fly for Aguilar. Far side of the field. Incomplete. Revis on him like glue. First time I think they've tested Revis all game, and that didn't work.
Sam Bradford had to take a shot. They brought everybody in. Darrell Revis showing why he's so good at man-to-man. Now, a little difference when you're Darrell Revis and you grab that right arm, that left arm, excuse me. They aren't so quick to call it, and he's earned that right.
Almost a block. Jones goes down, and Curley on the return. Makes Jenkins miss. Across the 30 is Jeremy Curley. So Pitt's defense again does their job. Get the ball back relatively quickly, but time a factor. Jets football down 10, only 4:48 to play. That's what the Jets are up against. 4:48 to play. They're down 10. They've got all three timeouts to go, and they start this drive on their own 31-yard line. Fitzpatrick over the middle. He's got a Nunwa making the catch, trying to fight his way forward. And he gets to the 36, but that's not going to cut it. Time, a big factor. Jets have to hurry here. Second and four. Fitzpatrick hit his throws, incomplete. John, I'm looking at this Dallas score. Falcons 39-28 now. They were down 14 as we look at the replay. I just had to ask you, what do you think Julio Jones is doing today?
Something big.
12 for 164 and two touchdowns.
What a player. We watched it right in front of our eyes here last week. Did it week one against these Philadelphia Eagles. What a player. And he's healthy now. And boy, is his talent coming to the forefront.
Third down and four for New York. Eagles showing blitz. Back off four-man rush near side. Marshall, penalty. Somehow he caught it. What a play. We got to see what the flag is, but that was some effort from Brandon Marshall. And the indication is on Philly. It'll be a first down for the Jets.
That route right there, that back shoulder fade is so hard to stop with Brandon Marshall.
Prior to the pass, holding defense number 31. Penalty is declined, the result of the play. First down.
You put yourself in Maxwell's shoes. You've got a 230-pound guy who can run, so you're worried about getting beat up top, and then he stops on a dime and uses that physicality to push off you. He draws a lot of penalties. Four penalties last week versus the Indianapolis Colts.
He's now got 10 catches for 109 yards and a touchdown as well. Fitzpatrick has time, going to dump it to Powell over the middle. A little shimmy shake. Still on his feet. Look at Powell. First down. What an effort from Bilal Powell.
Really, the most important thing about this drive, just get to field goal position, because it's a two-score game. So you need two scores. Doesn't matter what comes first, the field goal or the touchdown. But now getting real close to Nick Folk's range for a field goal.
3:45 and counting. Again, all three timeouts for the Jets, which if they can score, they'll use on D. They got to hurry up, though. Fitzpatrick batted down and incomplete. That one hung up there for a while.
Guess who? Brandon Bear. He's obviously figured out. You got a shorter quarterback. Ryan Fitzpatrick at 6'2". Get your hands up. That's exactly what Bear's doing.
Third deflection today for Brandon Bear. With Cedric Thornton out and Taylor Hart out. He has done the job.
All he's doing is mirroring the eye of Ryan Fitzpatrick and getting those hands up. It's been very effective.
And so a second and 10. And tipped, intercepted, I believe. Yeah, Philadelphia football. He got it in bounds. It was Walter Thurman. It's good for the interception. And that may seal it.
You see Brandon Marshall. I think he felt people around him. Felt like he was going to get hit. He kind of alligator armed that ball. Comes right off his hands and into the awaiting hands of Walter Thurman. This Philly defense has done one heck of a job today, and the Jets have hurt themselves throughout the course of the game.
Man, good concentration by Thurman to make the catch. Wasn't sure that's across the field from us if he got both feet in. But yeah, he did. And that should, for all intents and purposes, salt this game away.
I tell you, I couldn't be more impressed with Chip Kelly, with this Philadelphia Eagles team, because there was a lot of people thinking, you know what, you heard the whispers already, not even whispers. This game doesn't translate to the NFL. He's starting to be exposed. He made bad moves in the offseason. This team came to play, and they answered a lot of the naysayers. Only one win, but that will go a long way in giving them some confidence moving forward.
Timeout by the Jets. We were talking with Connor Barwin yesterday about the state of this team. And Johnny said you have to try and keep perspective and make sure guys stick together. But he said, more importantly, you got to win.
Exactly. You know, and I was joking about that thing with Pope Francis being in Philadelphia, them having to come. Sometimes that's the best. There's so much negativity the way they've played. Get out of town. And they went to Monmouth College in New Jersey and worked out as a team. Practices Friday, Saturday. They hung out at night having dinner. Sometimes that's the best thing. And it's really worked for them here today.
I think the one guy who enjoyed that was Miles Austin. He went to Monmouth down there and went to school there. But you know what? It's a good point. You know, they got away from all the negativity, get away from that for a little bit. There's Matthews. Over 100 yards for Ryan Matthews. And a Jets timeout. You know, there's only one place on television where bad is so good. This season on Gotham, villains will rise to a new level of criminal chaos. Gotham, Rise of the Villains. Catch an all-new episode tomorrow. Right here on Fox. I'd like to welcome those of you who saw the Falcons improve to 3-0 with a 39-28 win over the Cowboys. Here with the Eagles looking to wrap up their first win, Darren Sproles, John, has been the story.
Well, you see him catching the ball out of the backfield, blocking to give Sam Bradford time. A huge punt return, Kevin. He made five people miss on the tackles. Took it the distance. That really spurred the Eagles all day long.
Yeah, they needed it. It was 3-0 at the time. They made it 10-0, and it just gave them a little life for sure. And you talked about Chip Kelly and this team. But think about this. And just the NFL can just swing so totally in one week, right? So here are the Jets. They're 2-0, and they're looking great. And they come down to earth with a relative thud this week, right? And now the Eagles, who everyone was ready to write Chip Kelly off and go back to college and coach football. Well, now they're 1-2, and they've got the Redskins next week, who look pretty awful on Thursday night against the Giants. So, boy, do things change in one day.
That's why we got to let things play out in the season. We just saw a picture of DeMarco Murray not out there today. They ran the football better. Credit the offensive line for opening up those holes for Ryan Matthews and Darren Sproles.
That'll be a fourth down. Jets will call their final timeout. So the Eagles today with 123 rushing yards. They came in today with 70 total, and you're right, without Murray. I still don't know that we've seen the full complement of their offense. It got better, certainly, to do the job, but how do you think about their offense overall?
No, I think you're right, but I think they took care of what they needed to take care of. It started with the run game. They all talked about it, about production on first and second down.
Yeah.
Stop going backwards. Negative plays had to be eliminated. They've done a much better job. Jason Peters, we saw it when we talked to him. He was angry. He didn't like the way they played the first couple weeks. Well, they did something about it. They controlled a very good defensive line in the New York Jets, and credit to them.
Yeah, for sure. And give credit to Ryan Matthews. 22 carries, 104 yards today. 13th career 100-yard game. You know, the Eagles signed him. Well, wait a second. They got Murray and Matthews and Sproles, and what are they going to do with all these guys? It could be a pretty smart signing right now. Eagles will punt it away. Jets are out of timeouts. Here's Curley. They're going to make something happen. And he gets tackled up around the 49-yard line. Hey, coming up next after the game, the State Farm postgame show. Get you around the league with some of the highlights. Obviously, showed you or told you that the Falcons beat the Cowboys. Good one between the Panthers and Saints. Bengals trying to go to 3-0. And the Colts are back in front of Tennessee in what looks to be a wild game. They were on the verge of going 0-3. Patriots only scored 51 today. They had an off day. And how about the Vikings? After a Monday night opener against San Francisco where they looked just out of sorts. Impressive win last week. And now 31-14 today over the Chargers. 3 minutes, 2 seconds to go. Jets still hanging around down 10, but they're out of timeouts now. Fitzpatrick going to dump it across to Powell. Puts his leg in the ground, trying to find his way to bounds. Does so. Nice move. So the Eagles try to finish this one out and hold on. And who do they have coming up? Well, again, the Redskins next Sunday in D.C. Certainly a division rival, but a winnable game. And then at New Orleans, who is in danger of going 0-3 today. And then the Giants. So you know, a couple divisional games in there.
And the positive thing for the Philadelphia Eagles, when they started 0-2, their division, no one was taking it and running with it. So they're very much in this thing. A huge win today. We saw the stats about going 0-3. Not good. They responded, and you got to really applaud them for the way they did it.
High, nearly incomplete. Yeah, I mean, the Cowboys today, even though they got out to a quick start, lost without Tony Romo and Dez Bryant. They're going to be without them for a while. Giants finally got a win the other day, but the Redskins didn't look so good. But yeah, take advantage of your circumstance, I think, for sure. Pete Macheska, our producer today, Artie Kempner, our director, and our entire crew here from MetLife Stadium in northern New Jersey. Along with John Lynch and Pam Oliver, I'm Kevin Burkhardt. Eagles trying to finish this one out. 2:49 to play. 24-14. Second and 10 for Fitzpatrick and the Jets. He's got time, and they're going to throw it to Powell. Incomplete.
This Philly defense, the Eagles defense, have done a tremendous job of just keeping Ryan Fitzpatrick off balance the entire day, pushing the pocket, knocking down balls, different coverages in the back end, mixing man and zone. They've done a really nice job, and this defense really should be applauded for their work. They played a ton of snaps in the first 2 weeks of the season. Could have had a lot of excuses for breaking down. Instead, they've stayed together and really played well today.
Third and 10 for the Jets. Pressure. Fitzpatrick spins away, throws, just gets rid of it. Powell on the far side, gets out of bounds. And now you're looking at a fourth down and about eight.
See that Philadelphia defense. Eric Rowe, the rookie, challenged twice on deep balls, comes away with the pick and another incompletion. Nolan Carroll played well all day long. This Philly defense, you see Walter Thurman come down with the interception late in the game. They've been solid. There's Bill Davis, the coordinator.
Jets trying to stay alive. If they hit this, it's not over. Trying to make it a one-score game. It's a 53-yarder from Nick Folk. Quigley, the punter, will hold. Kick is up. And it is good. Hey, keep thinking, John, this game is over, just the way the feel of it. But they're out of timeouts, but there's still a chance. 2:34 to go. The Jets down 7. Eagles haven't been able to salt it away on offense.
And I think you've got to attempt the onside. You mentioned no timeouts. They'll get one stoppage of play with the 2-minute warning. But I think to give yourself a chance, you got to draw up your best onside play. Onside kicks much harder with the rules these days, not allowing people to overload sides truly. So the odds are against the Jets, but they still are kicking.
So the down 7, 2:34 to go, out of timeouts. Man, I'm with you. I think, you know, if they decide to kick it off, if they hold to a 3-and-out, they would get the ball back, but needing a touchdown without a timeout, that's a tall task. But we'll see what Todd Bowles decides. The kicker and the punter, both in the game for the Jets, Folk and Quigley. And
nice
Marshall.
Little formation, and Brandon Marshall looking like a halfback.
Jets not tipping. If they're going to do it, what side they're going to onside kick to with the dual kickers. Who's going to kick? They do a little fakeroo, and it doesn't work. Ajira Tutu, Shea Ajira Tutu, falls on it for the recovery.
It's the hands team. Ajira Tutu doing a really nice job of staying down on that ball, bringing it in.
You going for all kinds of misdirection there. The kick didn't bounce nearly far enough away. And so 2:32 to go. Jets out of timeouts. Get the 2-minute warning, but one first down would likely do it. Here's Matthews. Continues to add on to his total of 104 yards and counting with that carry. John Jason Peters, Pam asked him, Pam Oliver said, hey, is this a must-win? He said, oh, it's a must-win today. City of Philadelphia, man, they're tough. The fans are tough, but we're known for winning, and it's a grind city, man, right?
A grinding grit city, he called it. We asked Connor Barwin. He said, I don't like saying that, but it's pretty darn close. And
yeah.
I think they knew it. You go to 0-3, it's really tough, and they put out their best effort.
2-minute warning. Philadelphia trying to run out the clock on the Jets. Coming up next after the game, the State Farm postgame show. Here's the deal. 2 minutes left. Jets are out of timeouts. Eagles up 7. If they get a first down, the game's over. If the Jets hold here, they could get the ball back with about 30 seconds left, but they need a touchdown length of the field. So they need some help. A lot of it, as a matter of fact. 2nd and 8 for Philadelphia. Matthews again tries to get to the edge. Dragged down. Inbounds, so the clock will run.
I'll tell you, the one thing Ryan Matthews needs to do is get two hands on that football. He was carrying it loose right there. No reason to. Get two hands on the football, get downhill. He's had a history of fumbling that you chronicled, Kevin.
And so 3rd and 6, the Eagles will take it down as far as they can. First down will end it. If not, the Jets will still have a chance for a miracle. And they're going to take it down and looks like call a timeout here with a second left on the play clock. Taking as much time as they can. So, John, these Jets came in 2-0, right? And the defense was phenomenal. They were allowing 8.5 points a game. Some really good points about the Jets. Today, defense has not been as good. Offense has been out of sorts for parts of the game. What's your evaluation?
Well, the defense certainly is not dominant yet. You, like I said a couple minutes ago, you've got to earn that right. Now, I do think this defense is going to be one of the better defenses in football when it's all said and done. I said in the open also, I'm concerned about this offense. They haven't shown me enough. And we saw them get exposed a little bit as they got behind. They were missing Chris Ivory, missing Eric Decker. Yes, but when they get behind, can they catch up? They've been in very advantageous situations. They've been able to kind of manage the game. Well, that doesn't happen all the time. You've got to put points on it. So I think that's the concern moving forward. Can they keep up with people like New England who put up 50 points on a regular basis?
Yeah, and they've only averaged 2.9 yards a rush today against this Eagles defense. So here we go. This will be the game. 3rd down and 6. A first down would seal it for Philly. And we get a flag on Philadelphia. At least I think it's on Philly.
Illegal substitution. Yep. Offense had 12 men set with the snap imminent. 5-yard penalty, still 3rd down.
Welcome those of you who watched the Panthers beat the Saints 27-22. As the Panthers are 3-0, New Orleans 0-3. Here are the Eagles looking for a first down to seal this game. Up 7, 1:14 to go. Jets out of timeouts. 3rd and 11, and we get movement, and we'll get another flag. And that'll move the Eagles back again.
False start. Offense number 86. 5-yard penalty. 3rd down.
Now, Kevin, we've seen some sloppy football this year. This is coming out of a timeout. You have 12 men on the people on the field coming out of a timeout, then jump off a false start. And those kind of things can't happen. It doesn't hurt them because the clock, but still now field position, we talk about the 30 seconds the Jets will.
John, after the Hicks interception, this game should have been over.
Yeah. I mean,
it shouldn't even be a question right now, but the Eagles have kind of let it be. And now a 3rd and 16. They'll give to Matthews, try to run some clock. Flag again. Matthews gets hit, and this stops the clock here, which is huge. Let's see what the penalty is.
Looks like they're going to have it on the defense.
J. Gene Steratore, our referee, trying to sort this out.
Illegal use of hands, hands to the face. Defense, number 98, 5-yard penalty, automatic, first down.
Game over. Wow.
It's Quentin Copels right here. Is Quentin Copels working against Riley Cooper. Excuse me, against the left tackle, Matt Tobin. And you see the hand up in that face. Just a critical mistake when they couldn't have one.
Well, the Jets hung around and they made it interesting. But Chip Kelly's Eagles are back from the dead. They did what they had to do. They were 0-2 coming in. They didn't look like anything resembling a cohesive unit. But today, they exercised a lot of their demons by running the football and getting that first win.
Well, they outplayed the Jets. Sometimes you kind of luck into a win. Not at all. Chip Kelly and his team outplayed the Jets, which a lot of people didn't think could happen coming into today.
Ryan Fitzpatrick, too big of a deficit to overcome. They were down 24-0, and they made it a game, but it wasn't enough as the Eagles pick up their first win. And one of those weird anomalies, they've never lost to the Jets. 10-0 all time in their meetings with the Jets. As a hug with Todd Bowles and Chip Kelly, two head coaches. Sam Bradford wasn't relied upon much today, but he did enough to help this Eagles team pick up the win. That guy, Darren Sproles, one of the heroes. Eagles get the win. We'll come back to MetLife Stadium and wrap it up. 24-17, Philly over New York. The final score, Sproles a big hero today, as was the Eagle D, as they get their first win.